And he felt like, do I have to keep apologizing for something? So I think that's a valid question to ask. And I'll ask you, Don, because you were just talking about you're a member of the LGBT community. If someone makes statements that are inarguably wrong, flat out, no ifs, ands, or buts about it, and they've addressed it before and apologized for it before, if it comes up again, do they need to apologize again? Or, as he said in the first statement before he stepped down, listen, I've addressed this before, I've apologized before, I'm not going to keep doing this again. I'm not sure where the line is, and I'm not making a judgment on it, and I'm certainly not making a judgment on how anyone feels about it, because the tweets were ugly and they were wrong, period. But where is that line?
Yeah. Nichelle, I want to get to something, but I will say I think that you probably need to answer those questions for as long as it is an issue. Some things are so offensive, and even if they date back to, you know, from years in our past, I think in order to affect change when it comes to these issues, I think that people need to answer for them. If you think it was an issue that dealt with African Americans, if people had said disparaging things about African Americans in the past, I think they need to explain themselves. There's no difference to me here when it comes to the issue of LGBTQ rights, especially if you're telling a child, I would prefer you not to be gay. As we know, this is not something someone chooses.
This is not something you can pray away or wish away. I agree with you. It's just a question that I'm asking because it's a question that I'm hearing and a response that I'm hearing and seeing from some members of the community, some people out there, viewers. I've been searching social media, and that is something that people have been saying. Listen, how many times do you say I'm sorry? And I guess you're right.
As many times as it takes, Michelle.
You say I'm sorry as many times as it takes to not be offended anymore.
As many times as it takes.
Hey, one goal, one thing, one move, and that shit don't change. It's true. Real niggas do real fucking things. Real niggas do. Hey, there's only one goal, one thing, one move, and that shit don't change. And it's true. Real niggas do real fucking things. Real niggas do real fucking things.
I'm a shooter too, not just a farmer.
I can put this shit and I'll blow the brains out of your job, baby. What kind of shit is this?
Funny enough, bro, the first plug I had out there in Cali, kind of looked just like that fucking character. Had like the same kind of hat, the same shirt.
Them shorty pants with the ankles up.
It's me,
but
man.
But his hair wasn't like long. It's kind of like more like up.
I'm your weed man. It's weed man. Why nigga never told me about those goddamn major laser? I ain't never heard it. Heard of them.
It's been on Fox. That's funny. It's been becoming as a cartoon.
It's on FX.
That's even dope, but that means it comes on cable TV.
Yeah, because you know, Fox ain't going to put that on their broadcast.
That's coming up right now.
But, you know, that's what the FX is for, all the, you know, mature shit.
For the FX.
You hear me? Because, come closer, Joe, because lately you've been kind of following the mic. But,
Mike be kind of following me.
Oh, they got one over there.
Probably because I ain't been in my rolling chair.
Real. But, what I'm about to say, somebody, when I put it up on Facebook, nigga was like, man, but that shit years old, man. It was like 3-4 years ago. My son, I never heard of it. But we don't operate on cable, so if it's not something that really blow past cable, nigga ain't gonna really be on.
If it hasn't hit the social media spectrum,
The nets,
or some kind of internet of somewhere.
The nets, it got hit. The nets
all over the worldwide web.
You know what I'm saying?
Run fuck it.
But tears with tears, man.
That shit dope though. Did we finish? That was the whole episode, huh?
I was halfway through because she get the weed and then, you know, shit go a little left for her.
Oh, that was Trinidad James. That was probably rapping that guy.
That's why I sound familiar. Yeah. When you say that, nah.
It says guest starring Trinidad James.
And it's musical as fuck. I've only made it to like episode 3. So
that's his flow too. Mm-hmm. I'm your weed man. I got whatever you need, man. Don't ever touch none of my seeds, man.
Nigga.
So that was I ain't gonna lie. I don't never give that song his credit for being so like, cause
one verse. That's one elongated verse. It start with a hook. He rapped one long ass verse. Ends with the hook. And y'all, if nigga, he made his money, son. Talk about light work.
light work,
bitch.
But it was so because right it was so simple, but so like I don't know. It said everything you need to say.
Bruh, simplicity is genius, dog.
When you do it right,
live and die by that, dog. Like if you can come up with something really simple but you know, still good. Shit, that's the wave, son.
That nigga said, smoking mid, my nigga, don't pass that shit to me. Like, this
it's when it's when you find something that connects a bunch of people at once. You know what I'm saying? Your delivery, because nigga, he had a nice voice with it. He had a nice little laid back.
His
video
was ridiculous.
It's so much that goes into what goes into making a hit, but that was definitely a hit, dog. You can't take that away from him.
My nigga. And every time he said it, just like, you want to say it too. nigga.
Everything. I want to catch his songs that year.
Yep, it was.
I remember he had a song called Molly. Ooh, that Molly song, boy.
Yeah. None of them matched this one.
As far as
influence.
None.
Even though he had little hits. I mean, not
he's
hits.
He's still in the game.
Little songs. Yeah, he is. He is still in the game. I saw him featured on somebody's shit in somebody's video recently.
Yeah, he's still in the game.
He's more of a character now, though, because he's made a few cameos without spitting shit.
Like, he made some shit where he spit as characters. Like, he did, like, Black Santa, and he dressed with Santa, and made it, like, Black Santa come up in your house and jack up all you got. Black Santa give you boots when you touch. It was funny shit. Kind of like this, though.
Go
all in my watch.
My watch.
Why niggas, everybody on platinum and diamond, nigga, take it back to gold.
Yeah.
Don't you niggas never really left gold?
I think for the most part, niggas like Wayne, like really influenced niggas on that platinum level and shit. You know what I mean?
I'm saying cash money in general kind of started doing the whole platinum.
Yeah. But the thing about something about gold is so African to me, like so, like, you know, royal. You go all that gold.
Fuck nigga. You a real nigga that fuck with me. This one for the hood,
nigga. Hips the bitches that shop at Lennox. Dark skin, light skin. Asian and white.
Then you got the character.
You got this little puppy with me, this little pitch. Don't buy shoes. And last day.
My nigga.
And Magic City.
My nigga. They call match that shit with me. Smoking me. My nigga. Then don't pass that shit to me. This one for my
niggas. Bitches bout that money. Gotta
love. I just stop it right there. You smoking that mid, my nigga. Don't pass that shit to me. So if y'all didn't know, man, these are the Potty Mouth Pothead Podcasters in the building.
Yeah.
Flower Bass Podcast episode 71 or 72?
71.
71 side A. You feel me? You dig on our road to 100. 100 though.
Feel me?
This that actor guy, Martin Bass Bradford. You can find me on Facebook as Martin Bass Bradford on all your all your social media platforms as Mr. Bats. Spell that Mr. Outer, you ain't gonna find me. And we in this bitch, man. I'm here with my brothers.
And as usual, it's your boy D-Mac. Catch me on Instagram at FrenchBread.kid and follow my clothing line at YourDig504. And this episode, at least on this side, I'm gonna be saying what and how a lot because I can't hear out of my left ear because I got water in it. And it's really sucking right now.
Well, you went swimming?
No, I just took a bath and I, like, you know, just got under the water and sat there.
Who pussy you was eating?
I mean, I'm always...
Damn, in your ear?
I mean, yeah, man, that boy at DC, I'm a wow one.
Like I said, if I put my ear to the shell, I can hear the ocean.
I can hear the ocean. It's very therapeutic. You know what I'm saying?
Come on, y'all walk in that meditation and put them ears to that pussy.
No,
put them ears to that pussy, you're going to hear the world. You're going to hear the soul. You're going to feel better.
You really
will. You're going to hear something, that's for damn sure.
Somebody might start talking. I can tell
you. Yo, you're
on your situation.
You gotta run away.
My precious. Posse Wine, it's your boy Alma Joe. Fresh out of the gumbo, still deep in the room. And if you're out in the streets and you're looking for me, you can find me on IG at Joe No E
504.
Bitch.
Wow, you really haven't messed it up in a long time.
Since I said this on a review on that show the last episode. Since Marty poked that fun at him, this nigga's hit every one of them.
Every
dog.
Single one.
And I know he ain't thinking about Marty, but just funny how that
real
just
talk, it's not even about Marty, even though he came in like the perfect timing.
Perfect
timing. It's about how bad I fucked up.
That one time.
I understand. I can respect that. I respect that. I was like, that.
Son, I don't know my whole fucking tagline.
The actor lost his
line. Nigga, my line? I didn't remember monologues. Nigga, please.
Nigga, please.
Catches bullets with his teeth. Bullets with his teeth. Nigga, please.
And shouts out to everybody. Last Dragon's on Netflix.
Yeah, I seen that. I said, check that out.
Catches bullets with his teeth. But welcome to everybody listening, man. We in this bitch on a rainy ass day.
Yes, rainy night in Georgia.
So, I like the rain though.
I like the rain when we inside.
Yes.
I like the rain when I'm with someone I can touch and rub on.
Even better. This one of them days that you just like do drugs and like have a whole you, your girl, you and your guy type of date.
Yeah.
You know, I'm saying?
It's going to be a you day.
Yeah, man.
Like, go and get yourself together. You know what I'm saying? Watch your favorite videos.
Okay. My nigga.
It's pussy popping in Magic City.
Pussy popping.
I heard that.
Pussy. Yeah. Pussy popping in Magic City. So, yeah, y'all. Beside, man. We usually start off with that starter section. That's just some little hot topics, hot stories going on in the game, in the news, in the social medias, and all that there. Mm-hmm. After that starter section, man, after them appetizers, we get into that Bats Nerd Out moment.
Yes.
What niggas get a chance to, you know, nerd out on shit that's going on in TV, comics, and, you know, black shit. You know, whatever the fuck we feel like nerding about. We're some actors. We got a lot of little nerdtivities about us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So after that Bats Nerd Out moment, we go to Joe Sports Corner.
Sports! Fuck yeah!
You did. And I don't think I got a question of the day today, so we might forego that one. But we usually have a question of the day where niggas run it. I wish, you know, once again, hit us up at flywithbats@gmail.com. We want y'all to be part of the conversation, and being part of the conversation that will really help us out is sending us some questions. You send us a question, you can be that part, that sponsor for the question of the day. Yeah. And, you know, you'd be helping us out on the show as well. You know, you get a shout out and all that stuff.
Right, right.
But, yeah, man, before we get into the starter section, man, we got to pull out that scroll.
Unleash the scroll.
The scroll of all our partners, all our, you know, fellow podcasters that we know of color. That all the millennial all right, tip.
You know what would be funny, Zay? Next time you say unleash that scroll, we should like insert a horn or something like an actual some funny ass trumpet fair.
It just might happen, man. So starting off, and that means it's probably gonna happen this episode. Especially when you just did that, it might just come out of your mouth. The joys of editing. But anyway, starting off with your 30 podcast with Marty Edwards, my dude on the reviewing that podcast, and the Arrogant Observer. Hey, man, did y'all know that Lawrence is in a cult?
What?
What cult is he in?
Was. As a, like a teenager, preteen.
Damn, son.
What was the cult?
I don't remember the name of it. They talked about it on their most recent podcast.
Mm-hmm. It was called Evangelistic Church Praising God.
It was something weird like that, though, for real.
And it was like a little churchy type cult?
Man, he had to drop out the home. He said him and his mama went out there, and he had to go drop out the home. And the people kept on leaning on him. They leaned on his mama to sell her house so she could be closer to the church. Mm. And the church didn't want them to have friends outside the church.
What?
You weren't supposed to watch. It was boo-coo shit, nigga. Wow. Go listen to he break that shit down. Go listen to your 30s.
Sounds like some Jehovah Witness.
Nigga, Mormon. It was beyond that. But it wasn't Mormon because, you know, they don't got that in the South, and it wasn't like white. Well, and the one black Mormons,
boy,
the black Amish, the black Amish.
But we had to go off of this shit, boy.
Well, I'm glad you didn't drink the Kool-Aid, bro.
I mean, he said his entire time there he hated it, but his mom was trying to be open-minded because I think it was his uncle that got them into it. You know what I'm saying? And they were just trying to focus on at least just the God part, even though they saw shit was weird.
Yeah.
But then shit got too weird. So it was like, nah.
Bring out the sacrifice.
Nah. And he was saying all this shit. Oh, shit. And he said, you could Google all this shit. If I was remembering any names, we could pull them up. I don't. So I just tell everybody, go check out the Your 30 podcast. Get Lawrence's.
Charles Manson.
What about Charles Manson?
You're about to die.
Nigga. Yeah. It was good.
You need me to call an ambulance?
Because then I couldn't get it out of fast, and a nigga said, nigga, pull up. Knew these people, I was going to be like, Charles Manson, this shit, a real cult.
It's like, Lawrence, you was in a fucking cult.
Oh, real world. Right? Coco. Nah, you was in a cult.
Thank God you didn't drink that Kool-Aid, nigga.
Nigga, you wouldn't be here.
I'm glad you're here, bro.
Yeah, I mean, what's your Jim Jones? But that's the Kool-Aid, man. Yeah. But shouts out to Your 30. Catch their newest episode. Something else they were talking about.
What did Charles
Manson
do? Did he have a cult too? Charles Manson.
Charles Manson was like a serial killer type, but he also have a cult though. I think he did have some followers.
He had a
cult
because he was a serial killer.
It was one of the two.
Yeah, he had some people with him though, but he known for that fuckery.
Okay.
But Jim Jones had the people slip that Kool-Aid.
Okay, he's the one that the people slip.
Brought him to the crime scene.
I get them often mixed up. Jim Jones and the nigga I last said.
Bring him to. They about to make a Charles Manson movie. Funny enough, I think it's Tarantino.
They all kind of like run together.
Was an American criminal and cult leader, see? In the late 1960s, he formally became known as the Manson Family, a quasi commune in California. His followers committed a series of 9 murders at 4 locations. So, yeah.
Oh, so y'all was a cult of killers.
Serial killer cult. They were the serial killer cult.
All right, dog.
Okay, Manson.
I think Bale
is playing him, or Leo.
Oh, talking about, I guess we'll get to the near that moment. We're talking about what Christian Bale about to play as Dick Cheney.
Oh, we've been kind of hinting on it. We could jump back into it. Or maybe it was on review. I get confused. But it's interesting that that boy looked just like Cheney. Boy, Tyler Perry looked just like motherfucking Colin Powell.
I was like, boy, Tyler Perry, you about to really get some respect off me in this acting role of your chops, my nigga.
Nigga, he looked just like him. I was like, all right, Perry.
You, boy, what?
So, is Brad Pitt and Leo are both in this Manson movie?
That's
going to be intense.
That's going to be psycho.
So Leo playing Manson. Oh, it's going to be sick. Yeah.
Brad going to be the one catching him?
Let me make sure. Brad, okay. According to Deadline, DiCaprio and Pitt will play Rick Dalton and Cliff Booth, a former TV star and a stunt double who are living in Los Angeles in 1969. In a statement released by Sony Pictures, Tarantino describes his film as a story that takes place in Los Angeles at the height of hippie Hollywood. Both men are struggling to make it in Hollywood. They don't recognize themselves anymore. But Rick has a famous next-door neighbor, Sharon Tate. Tarantino has also announced the film's title, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, and a release. And the release date has been August 9th, in which the pregnant Tate then married to Roman Polanski, along with 3 friends and a visitor to the house's caretaker, were killed by Manson acolytes Charles Tex Watson, Susan Atkins. So who's playing Manson? Marilyn Manson.
See, like, they're just all, like, squished together in my brain.
I mean, that's how pop culture has it. Damon Harriman is going to play Charles Manson in the Quentin Tarantino film. Oh, he looked like that nigga.
Okay,
he looked like a cult leader weirdo. Go get him.
I say, go get him, dude.
Go get him. But, like, yeah, so all I have to say, go check them out on Your 30. We got black cult stories, y'all. Also, the On the Lake podcast with Rel, the protagonist, Chelsea Is Me, Sleeping Beauty, and Frankie Cola.
They just got on iTunes.
They just got on iTunes. Yeah. Go hit them up. Now whenever I get my phone back, I can catch up with them easier.
They're on break too, but I think they're recording something today, so I'm sure they got a new episode on the way.
Go get them on the leg, baby. The Misbelieve Radio Show podcast hosted by DC Pauls with also Oshun Lilith, Malik the Historical Geek, Fat Girl, Nola J. Steele, my other reviewing that co-host, and us, the We'll Figure This Out podcast with Jay Skills, Lodo, I'm all fucked up today, Lido the God, and Kiki, 4 Misses in the Mic with CJ, CCL, and Bree. They're on break right now, but catch all their back episodes, man. Them joints are popping. Therapy Noir podcast with Roxy's Way and El Nichelle. Sugar Assassin Sarcasm podcast with Kanae and her sisters. Hip Hop Nerd podcast, Glory Jones. 50420 podcast with Sam the Magic Man. And I keep fucking up Ezekiel, right?
Ezekiel?
Yeah, Zeke. Isn't Ezekiel something, though? Pork?
I can't remember. Strange Pork?
I once knew a guy named Strange Pork. But anyway.
I'm not touching that.
The Fuck With Your Herd podcast. The Metal Hand of God podcast. Black Guys Next Door podcast. No Dope on Sundays. Teapot. Talk Brothers. Home Video. Hot Hustle podcast. And The Living Millennial podcast. So, yeah, man. That's all the people that's currently on them. If y'all got podcasts that are specifically local in New Orleans or in Louisiana every year, but we stretch some time with people that we fuck with, let us know. We'll shout them out once again at flowerpass@gmail.com. So, without further ado for this side A action, let's get into the starter section.
Let's do it.
Lying about how much you had made. Rumors and shit that you handmade. Would you buy this if I sold that? Hey, what the hell is my soul at? The American need for American green is America's greed. That's the American dream. Black America too busy chasing white American dreams. But we sleep, so let's everybody eat then repeat. Where the fuck the cheese? Where the mozzarella at? Tell me what it be.
So, Kevin Hart.
Are we starting off with this cat?
Kevin Hart.
What happened?
He took over the news recently. He took over the world, man. Oh, you ain't been paying attention, D?
No.
Oh, that's hilarious.
Wow.
That's good. I love it when that happens. Somebody give me a lighter so I can spark it up.
I got you, dog.
As we talk about the heart of all things.
Go, I know what.
I knew he was going to give me the middle finger. I knew he was going to give me the middle finger with this. Here you go, sir. Fuck you. Anyway. Thank you. It's still within the hand. You're a gentleman and a scholar. So anyway.
First it's sour.
Then that's sweet. That motherfucker. So anyway, bro. So what you basically missed is Kevin Hart, he was tapped to be the host of the Oscars.
Okay.
And then it came out. Yeah, then it came out these tweets from like 2009 that were homophobic as fuck.
Ah.
And then the Oscars was like, hey, Kevin, you got to at least apologize for this shit, my nigga. Kevin, like, my nigga, I didn't apologize before enough times. I don't feel like playing into the trolls.
So he's already apologized for this.
Previously, he's apologized previously for this. He said, I'm not about to just keep on doing it and doing it. Okay, I was like, well, my nigga, they got a lot of people that's new to these tweets, basically. And if you apologize, it's more like they're newly offended who didn't know about your apology. So, my nigga, can you apologize just so we can be clear? Kev, like, I'm standing my ground. Oscar's like, Kev says he stepped down. Uh-huh. So I'm going to just go with what he said.
Oscar said, he put out a video first saying that the Oscar's telling him that he didn't need to apologize or they're going to make him step down.
Yeah, that's what he first said. And then in his next video, he said he stepped down. But I mean, like, come on. Yeah. Oscar said, bitch, if you don't apologize,
we're going to get some fucking body else.
So he decided.
Chris Rock will be back again.
Yeah, like, it's not that fucking difficult.
So. He said he decided to step down.
Okay.
And he still then, after stepping down, apologized. So, yeah.
Oh. All right. Okay. Some people say that him apologizing after stepping down is really for his fans to be like, hey, listen, all right, I want to make this genuine. I want to let you know that, you know, the Oscars or the committee has nothing to do with my decision. Fuck them still, but I want to apologize to y'all, let y'all know. I guess he's trying to be very genuine. And he can be seen as that. Me personally, overall, out of this whole thing, I think that at the very beginning he should apologize and did PC control from the very beginning. PR control. Because, like, alright, yep, you apologized for it before, but son, this is the Oscars. Mm-hmm. You're about to enter a whole nother level of stratosphere.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And in this level of stratosphere, also, not only with that, I'm going to add the layer on, but also you putting on this cape that you're kind of like the hero comedian that's been helping everybody so far and defending everybody at every will.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? You got to at least address it. Even if you were to say, in my opinion, hey, I said I apologize before, but for those who didn't hear me, I want to let it be known on this platform right now that I apologize again. I don't even know why it's still up there.
Mm-hmm.
This, that, and the third. I'll handle all upon that, but I sincerely doesn't. Da, da, da.
Mm-hmm.
And then if
that's
if,
not
if,
very difficult to do.
It's not.
And let's say we go like a step further, just to make it another, just to put the knife in the gut for real.
What you saying now?
I'll go to a black LGBTQ summit and donate. Sponsorship,
here's the spice it up, you know, and delete all these tweets that's still been up here. My bad that they've been up here, because that's the thing that niggas will always still have. Even if you apologize before, you should have deleted the tweets. Just to show your good faith, because not only do they have these old, because that's the only part I'm mad about is it's 10 years old shit, and I'm gonna get to that in a second. But just on the merit, on the strength of what you're saying, Joe, on being a PC motherfucker, not even just saying a PC motherfucker, a businessman,
a good businessman, and a do-gooder.
You already know motherfuckers gonna come for you, and they're gonna find ways to come for you.
We're gonna look for cracks in the armor.
In the armor, and especially when, like you just said, Joe, you present yourself as someone to look up to as a role model. You know what I mean? So if you present yourself as a role model and you say that you're sorry and you apologize, that's part of the work. But like niggas saying, there's people that didn't know about these tweets that you've offended now. You can't just once you've done wrong, you can't just sweep it on the road and rug and be like, it's only these people problem, because you're out in the spotlight. Like, you're out in the spotlight. So that's going to always...
Wait.
That's going to always follow you.
Let me present one thing, though. and maybe I'm just tripping, but doesn't... Okay, so should he have to basically say he's sorry for the rest of his life for whoever doesn't know about his past history?
No. The thing is...
His checkpoints, I believe.
I'm just saying, because he said he was sorry the first time they told him about the shit.
But now it's another stratosphere. Remember, we're going talking about we're at the Oscars.
I'm just saying though, like everybody is not gonna know everything about you.
True that.
So I'm just saying. So every time it comes up from like groups of people that never knew about it and they're outraged now, should they have to apologize?
Don't leave with your ego.
All right, I'll say this.
Don't leave with your ego, and that's what he fucked up at. He led with pride and ego.
You don't have to apologize every time. But your actions after you apologize should have other people to come to bat for you to where you don't have to apologize. The thing is, your work's shown for this.
I agree with the fact that
your work hasn't shown any of this, people have now are able to say, well, you get like, well, like it still seems kind of fresh. You may not have made another gay joke again, but your thing is, you have not grown for like we were talking about this.
But you better give me mine. He said shit I told him yesterday. I'm about to say, but this sounds familiar.
Y'all already had this conversation.
That, yeah,
it was lightweight.
We spoke about it off mic previously, but we weren't saying the same shit. And then we came to a certain conclusion, but he still got his ideas and I still have mine. But at the end of the day, this is what most people say, Sam. Even though you could be apologetic, it's not on everybody to be accepting your apology or even knowing about your apology. You did wrong. I feel like people grow from decade to decade to decade. So I feel like it's kind of uncomfortable to be judging somebody 10 years later knowing that we grow. But
I got to think about that because we crucify people for shit like that all the time.
Yes, but you know that's another topic I want to get into after this. But I want to piggyback off the fact of he's in the public eye and like what Joe said, how he presents himself. You want to play ball, this is the thing you got to do.
I agree with that, yeah.
This is playing ball. Whether it's fair or not is one thing.
Yeah.
You want to play ball, and you trying to keep the money, you trying to get still be the number one comedian in the
you
world.
You asked to do the fucking Oscars.
Come
nigga.
On, son. Mm-hmm. If you want to get this money, you want to get these sponsors, that's
you,
part of yeah, playing
like
ball.
You do have to play ball. You know what I mean?
You're on a different level than me or you. You know what I mean?
And this nigga up here. And he also, like, where's the cape of being, like, the whole, you know, for everybody's rights. And
to a point, you have too much influence. You know what I mean? You have so much influence because of who you are and where you are.
You done kids' movies at this point.
And you out here with tweets that you didn't delete saying that I don't want my son to be gay. It's like, son,
and the thing is,
I whoop his ass.
Should have deleted that.
And the thing is to be like, I apologize already, deal with it.
Boom, that's not
the route to go.
Boom, that's what I'm saying. He led with ego. It was like you said from the dump of this conversation.
Is that how it came off when he
because
like, I haven't seen any like video of him like addressing this shit. Like, you know.
I can tell you this, dog. The majority scale sees Kevin Hart coming off as egotistical in this.
In this situation.
And prideful. And the thing
is, I don't follow the mob mentality, first of all, I haven't seen him like speak on it yet.
Even though it's my mentality, majority of certain things, you got to give it its credit. Like, nah, dog, everyone is obviously saying you're a fool. We all aren't stupid. You know what I'm saying?
I see what you're saying. I'm just saying,
but not necessarily because when I say majority,
be right about shit. They just think that's
very true too. But it's just like, this shit was so blatant, that's why it's so majority.
Yeah,
like, it's so obvious.
Here we go. This is what I need. Like, y'all gotten this concept.
I don't think this is the one I'm looking for, because when I'm looking for, he was laying down.
Right.
I don't know if this might be the one after everything. No,
like,
this,
I need something like this.
I'm looking for the one where we got the shades on, he laying down, he like, now I'm tired of apologizing.
Well, y'all done deleted that, boy.
I'm about to say what there it is right here. He said he already deleted
it. Somebody got it. It's on the internet.
I chose to pass. I passed on the apology. The reason why I passed is because I've addressed this several times.
Hey, man, I don't care about y'all this show. Get to the shit I want to see.
I've spoken on it. I've said where the rights and wrongs were. I've said who I am now versus who I was then. I've done it. I'm not going to continue to go back and tap into the days of old when I moved on and I'm in a complete different space in my life. The same energy that went into finding those old tweets could be the same energy you put into finding the response to the questions that have been asked.
It's only 140 words, dog.
What up, guys? Welcome to Indie.
I don't care about
it's only 140 words, though, dog, or less, that you could have said to easily wipe this shit away in the blink of an eye. you act like this shit wasn't like it was a very hard task.
We coming back.
You can pause it unless he
stop.
Get older. I don't know what to tell you. If you want to hold people in a position where they always have to justify or explain their past, then do you. I'm the wrong guy, man.
Now, when you
all this other shit. But, yeah, man.
Son.
I mean.
You're going too hard about defending this shit, dog. I get it at some level, dog.
If you are, okay, like, I'm having trouble reconciling the fact, even though I've never seen the previous apologies that he's done for this, he seems really adamant about, like, the fact that he's, like, addressed it in the deepest way that he could.
What's the big deal, though?
As long as you keep
like you said from dump, well, it's so hard just to be like, okay, for this Oscar situation.
Yeah, that's not difficult.
Because this is a higher platform that's seeing these tweets.
120 words on these tweets.
I just think both of those are valid, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, I think he could have said something, but then I also feel like what he's also saying about the fact that he's spoke on it before is also valid. Like,
and the Oscars are very gay friendly too, son. You can't like very gay friendly, like strong supporters. Yeah. With strong support.
It's valid, dog, but once again, if you want to play ball, feel me? You apologized 5 years ago, and now you got 5 years more fans.
And your tweets are still a fuck up there.
Now you got an answer for why your tweets up there, and now you have 5 years worth of new fans that didn't know about that apology 5 years ago. And if you know that you're wrong about it, it's not that hard to be like, yeah, my bad, whoopty. It's like, it's really simple if you want to play ball. Now, if you don't want to play ball, I'm not going to judge you if you don't want to play ball, but you got to take what comes with that.
I think there's a funny part of me that also believes that even if he would have took that shit down then, like, he would still be getting judged for it.
They wouldn't have the ammo. You know? All that he would
have found is now.
Yeah.
Like, it didn't come up like this in the third. Nigga found us in this moment, and it wasn't too hard to find.
I'm just saying, like, when famous people tweet things like that, like, those get screenshotted and saved for, like, posterity.
Yeah, you could do like that screenshot, you know, and save, so. But the thing is, like,
his credibility to say that he apologized before is shot the fact when he keeps up the tweets.
When the tweets are still up there, I totally get that.
And then now they've been up for years.
And then then defend it in the sense of, like, man, I'm tired of apologizing for the shit.
Well, nigga, I don't want to say he's defending the tweets like that. Like, that sounds a little bit...
All right, let's say he's not defending the tweets. But let's say he's being too...
He's defending the fact that he apologized for. He's too butthurt about an
action that he's got to suffer a consequence for.
Wait, say it again?
I feel like he's too butthurt about an action that he got to suffer a consequence for. Like, you wrote this.
I think that's also true.
So, here go his tweets on it. And here go another thing, too.
It's just a very varied thing.
And here go another thing, too, when you deal with comedians. A lot of things that they say in jest, they want to be able to just say they shit and
they
that's
just hiding behind comedy?
Not hiding behind comedy. I'm saying that's part of the craft of it, too.
Hiding behind comedy.
I'm not saying that necessarily, because you know what I'm saying. Like, some comedians, like, they might, even if, what he said, his tweets were like, they were how he felt, but they were in jest in the way, is the way how he explained it. Now, if you want to go in jest, fine. But, like, a lot of comedians are like, man, you shouldn't make a comedian apologize for his jokes. A lot of them come from that mentality of that culture. I ain't saying that's right or wrong. I'm not saying that's right or wrong, because it depends on where you fall into what comedy is. And so, because comedy can hurt. You can say it's just jokes, but then those jokes can lead to actions and people having a mentality. Then we got gay people getting beat up. Then we got them at Etouffee. A gay couple got murked in Las Vegas for being gay. It's like, goddamn, we still doing this shit.
Yeah, we need context, because the thing is about a joke and about a tweet. You know what I'm saying? And that's what separates Kevin Hart out of this from the situation. Because, like, some comedians, like Bernie Mac, who joke can be seen as today as a little homophobic, he did about the boy with the little cook.
A lot of comedians.
I mean, as times change. And once again, people try out their jokes on Twitter.
But that, in that moment of what was stated, if you look at the tweet, doesn't seem in any kind of way of a joke.
That wasn't, like, material.
It wasn't material. You know what I'm saying?
He used that material in one of his stand-ups before, though.
When?
When his early one. Somebody put that up. And I was like, oh. You know what I mean? I got to find... I'm not about to go through my Facebook wall. Son. Somebody...
So he made the same joke in a routine.
A version. It wasn't the same thing. So far, we know he could be covering that ass for all I know. You know what I'm saying? Because they say it was a version. Nigga put up the video. And I was like, interesting. But... I hear what you're saying, Joe.
And
either way, it's still up there, and it's still how you feel.
It's a joke first, nigga.
Either way,
when you put it on words,
once it's written out in text, you're accountable. You know what I mean? Whether you were joking or you were serious, once you wrote that shit up, ain't for everybody to get your jokes, nigga.
whether it was in jest or serious. So I ain't fighting you on it at all. I'm just saying what they were saying about it, just to put that story out there.
Know what I'm thinking though, son? Like, comics make offensive jokes about people all the time, dog. Like, every group of people, like, whether it's white people, black people.
There's lines, though, they know not to cross.
Now you're stepping into the current fight in the comedy world.
Let me finish.
No. Okay, when you finish, I'm going to be saying the same thing.
Okay, well, I just won't fucking say it then.
You can finish, son, because you talking about how they make offensive jokes. And I'm saying that's what's going on in comedy. No.
What I was about to say was, like, okay. People make jokes about people all the time, but we don't make people say they're sorry for all those jokes all the time. It seems like we only make them apologize sometimes, depending on who's being offended. No?
I think it's about platform. The higher you go, the more niggas going, like all depends on what
it'll just
you
be
go.
Like more stricter on your comedy.
And it's also part of the character that you present yourself to be.
Right, that's also too. Because the thing is, like, I don't think that no one's asking Cat Williams to apologize for anything.
But they're not holding him to that same regard.
Right. Oh, instance of like homophobia.
But again.
Right.
Again, exactly.
But Cat Williams is not saying also, I'm out here giving comedians a chance. I'm saving niggas. You know what I'm saying?
You're right.
You kicked this ball over in my sister's yard. Now I'm the one taking over the yard. Well, now there's a little crack in your armor, dog, and you could have easily healed it with a few tweets.
That's true. I mean, like you say, Martin, like it just really depends on how you present yourself.
What I'm saying is, from the beginning, I'm my bad for cutting you off, but that's the same thing I was saying. Like in the comedy world right now, a lot of comics are mad because the quote unquote PC, and I hate that fight about the PC shit because out like bigots and racists and right wingers use the world's getting too PC as a way to cover their bullshit. But it's happening in the comedic realm where a lot of comics feel like we can't be as daring as we used to be. Like even the bigger ones like Jerry Seinfeld stand up for this reason. Like people like it's going layered throughout shit. And I've been reading up on it and I'm like, I'm in mixed on it. Because on one end, I do want you to be able to say your shit. Because that's how the classic comics did. But it's still like we are in a world where we do have a responsibility once we get to a certain level. So I've been very split on this topic. That's why I said that's what you're stepping into when you talk about that. And I'm like, I don't know on that because I see both of them sides too clear.
The thing is, you need to be in this day's audience, dog.
And the community is evolving.
The community is evolving, dog. And we as a culture are getting more hyped to a lot of things that are being like things that are just not funny.
Or shouldn't be
funny. But the thing is, it's not that you don't be raw anymore. You just got to be raw about different things now, you know what I'm saying? You got to be raw about a different reality. You don't be raw about what the stereotype of what gayness is. Be raw about what real gayness is.
You make me
raw about what real life is.
You make me think about when you listen to wrestlers talk about how when they had to make the change from being like the Attitude Era and they could say what the fuck they wanted to then they had to be PG. And some of them say like it's not even that, you just got to be more clever. You got to be smarter. You know what I mean? If it's going to evolve, if you're still a talented motherfucker at what you do, you're still going to do it without cursing 50 times. Or, you know what I mean?
I'm calling out such. Or Chappelle did it.
Right. Or being homophobic. Or being whatever. So you're saying, so I guess we're saying that comedians shouldn't be complaining about this. They should be finding how to make it work.
Right. Dog, the times have changed. In football.
And change
in the
with
sports
them.
Of football. You're
right. Come on, run your
and,
shit.
And anything that ever fucking evolved throughout time, things change. You got to evolve with that, dog. Mm-hmm.
What about in music? Like, because there's like a lot of music that we can say is homophobic and
not as much as it used to be, sexist
and stuff.
I mean, hell, we came a long way from "Baby It's Cold Outside."
You know what I'm saying?
What?
Like, you know, like.
Well, I mean, yeah, that's a fucking decades old song, but I'm just saying, in the current climate of stuff, like, should we have the same scrutiny?
I think they are getting the same scrutiny.
I mean, R. Kelly's got canceled on a couple of playlists. But no, Chris Rock's got canceled on a couple of playlists.
I feel like they are like, dude, like, they be articles on damn near anybody and everybody, and when we can't say about hip hop now, when the last time you heard somebody relevant say faggot? You know what I'm saying? They used to say that shit in the 90s.
You know what? In the rap game, nigga. Last words I heard it say it was Rick Ross on the diss track.
And look how old Rick Ross is. So he come from a different era. But we saying these new niggas coming up, they not really being homophobic in their raps like that.
Nope.
It's funny. It's something to notice and I never thought about till you said that. Like, I can't think of a new
like,
artist.
Biggie said, man, before he'll fuck Escape, he'll fuck RuPaul. Drake, you know what I'm saying?
Son, Pac, all of them. You can do almost all of them, says some homie.
Like hard, hard yeah. shit.
That's yeah. a different time, dog.
I mean, niggas used to also get beat up for just even calling you some kind of gay shit like that. You know what I'm saying?
Well, if you wore tight pants, you was gay. So here's his most...
And everybody wore skinny jeans and skinny pants in the school now. I've been watching the boys coming to the basketball court. All of them got skinny. Every last one of them, Martin. Every last one of them. Had it all like, of straight them up,
Martin.
Son.
All of them, Martin.
I was like, there was not one pair of Dickies with a cell phone pocket in sight. I said, what the fuck is this?
Yeah, it's like, what's that movie? What's the movie with Channing Tatum, man? 21 Jump Street, where they went back to school.
Yeah.
And this shit that was cool ain't cool no more.
Right.
Nigga, what one strap book sack? Nobody wearing one straps no more. Everybody got their book sack on.
Right.
Because that's how you wear a fucking book sack.
Why you sagging? Real sag, no more.
Stupid ass nigga, sag. Man, put a belt on, man. What's wrong
with you? Here's Kevin Hart's most recent tweets about it. I've made the choice to step down from hosting this year's Oscars.
Sure you did.
This is because I do not want to be a distraction on a night that should be celebrated by so many amazing, talented artists. I sincerely apologize to the LGBTQ community for my insensitive words from my past. I'm sorry that I hurt people. I'm evolving and I want to continue to do so. My goal is to bring people together, not tear us apart. Much love and appreciation to the Academy. I hope we can meet again.
That's classic. Fine. I mean, that's fine.
Perfect.
Classic. It just really we'll sounds see like he just like,
I don't want to lose my shit.
Ball, you know what the cleanup about to be after this? It's about to be a whole gay comedy tour from Kevin Hart right now. Like, it's about to go down. The LGBTQ about to have a whole comedy tour of a Q for comedy.
Quality.
Dog, like, he's about to go 7 fetch right now. And you know what? You need to.
Son, he would have just been, fucked up. This is what he would have just said from the dump.
Yeah, if he'd have said that from the beginning.
He'd have played Gooch.
Dog.
It wouldn't have been nothing.
Fucking up.
But this is what happens when you mix that douce and your pride and your Philadelphia ways.
Because motherfuckers is
your
still
street nigga ways.
That's why you're from Philly?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Street. He's motherfuckers still getting
messed up for wrong mentalities, dog. Y'all saw that meme about like the straight nigga talking about how this gay nigga was like so happy he was treating him well because he wasn't used to straight niggas treating him well.
Yeah.
And I was like, damn, that's deep.
I get that often, son.
Me too. That's deep. You're right. You're right. Damn.
Like, they...
You
like,
right?
They, like, really be kind of, like, thrown off by, like, just us just being, like...
Genuinely cool.
Genuinely just, like cool.
You
don't
want to fight
like,
me?
Yeah. Like, no.
It's not 1998.
Or not even fight. You know what I mean? Like, talks... You know, be weird.
Right. Yeah, be weird. Like, not be around me.
Yeah.
I remember back in the day, man, nigga thought, like, you just touch a gay nigga, you had AIDS and shit like that. Like, niggas was, like, stupid thoughts, dog. Yeah. Like, ignorant thoughts. Caveman thoughts.
It was ignorant, yeah.
Don't put your earring in your right ear. Now, here go my head.
Yeah,
go my
son.
Shit like that.
It turns you gay on the side. Like some kind of Goku transformation now.
So I had a back and forth on my phone on the Kevin Hart post with this dude who just was like going hard up about, man, gay ain't right. I don't care, gay ain't right. You can't spin it.
Christ.
And I'm like, damn, in 2018, like, there's a damn, we going back and forth. He's like, I don't care how you spin it. I was like, but this and this and this. Is, I don't care how you spin it. I don't care how you spin it. It just ain't right. You like, you're supposed to have babies. I was like, so we only here to just have babies? No. So then what about people? So I guess you put like people who decide not to have kids in the same pot as gay people because they're deciding not to have babies. I'm just saying it ain't right. It ain't right. Stop spinning it.
You are way too elevated to even engage.
God didn't want it.
Mongrel,
God didn't want it. Why did God make us in this image and let gay people still be around? Man, stop spinning it.
People are crazy, bro. I told you that woman last podcast, dog, came into a full circle of gay niggas and was like, I know how y'all get down, but y'all need to be making babies with black women.
What is it
about y'all just making children?
Right. They swear that the world's gonna end. Dog, you do know everything balances out, dog. Gay people is not gonna cause the end of the world. The world is not about to turn gay. And everybody's not gonna stop fucking.
You think overpopulating and big gonna stop the world from ending? They all gonna die.
Right, if you go the other direction, you still fuck. What we all keep fucking? Everybody be fucking. Right. Everybody had kids.
That's why they gonna end the world, bitch.
Y'all so crazy. Nah, but deep. But what I want to talk about what we brought up earlier, that I talked about this on Facebook. That's my fear. That
you overpopulate the world?
Shut the fuck up. That I don't like with this the precedent that this practice of going so far in the past to judge the present.
Yeah.
That part bothers me. Now, I will say that makes me a hypocrite to a degree because I wasn't caring when Roseanne tweets got her fucked up. But I'm
they were fresh.
That was fresh. You're right.
The bitch is brand new.
True that, dog.
On the show they
still like, I'm understand, just saying like,
the wave of getting a nigga canceled through public opinion. If there's a nigga I ain't fuck with, I always said fuck him. But there's this one time where like, and that the one time I slowed up and was like, wait, hold up, where can this go? And I was with James Gunn, the director of Guardians of the Galaxy. Now, like once again, another situation was like 10 years ago. You feel me? He was trying to be a stand-up comedian. He'll try out these whack-ass pedophile-type jokes on his Twitter page and shit. Now, since that time, he's apologized. He done the work. He done given to the right people, said the right shit, et cetera, et cetera. And he, you know, was a Democrat, you know, liberal-type motherfucker that'll be on Twitter constantly, like, either trying to get people to vote against the right-wingers and the racist people or talking shit to them because he knew his shit. Fighting a good fight. Mm-hmm. So then these people on that side to use how Roseanne and them types have been canceled, their types have been canceled, went and found his old tweets on this gate, on this weird ass pedo shit, and got him fired from being Guardians of the Galaxy director.
All right, so check this out. Were the tweets still up and live?
I don't remember. I don't remember that detail. Still alive because either way, go, you can still, like, DC, you can find old tweets no matter what. So I don't remember this detail.
If it's in the detail that they're still up online, that you can grab them easy like that, you fucked up.
He did fuck up, but I will say this as well. Not everybody thinking about their old tweets.
No,
I get what you're saying. Once you get to a certain level, you gotta be on it. Real. But you get what I'm saying. What's fucked up though is the enemy this time, just to hurt this man because he was fighting a good fight, got him fired and used the same wave. You hear me? Now let's say Kevin Hart didn't react like he did. Let's say he was gracious and shit. You feel me? What if these motherfuckers was doing this to bring this man down and we riding all these waves because of new offenses, even if it wasn't meant? Now, it just scares me how this shit could go because Kevin Hart, he was a bad example. But like recently, there's some younger stars that's in their early 20s. They got in trouble for high school tweets. And at a point, Twitter going to be that old to where you can bring up high school tweets on people that's like 27, 28. It's going to get to that point. So then they're going to be answered for shit they said when they was 15 and 16. Cause you're doing it to him now.
I have a real problem.
Shit that's what I'm afraid of. I'm saying like, you know, it has worked against the fucked up people, but one day some activist that saw the light gonna be riding hard and fucking heavy that might have accidentally forgot that they said some fucked up shit on Twitter. Humans are humans.
The thing is,
you know what I'm saying? And then the enemy bring down a big type nigga because we on this ask questions later shit. Right. And I'm saying this shit can't be useful, but let's ask questions too.
If a nigga pull it up. Especially like with some high school dog, just account for what you said, account for what the time is in, account for where you are, and move on.
A person is smart, people are stupid. Is
If people move stupid like that, dog, you ride the wave of forgetfulness.
You're gonna ride it, dog.
Once they forget, you're back on another wave with these niggas.
Forgetfulness is real, son. Because like
in this culture, niggas think they can go by with shit fast.
Posts like,
but some niggas like, be taken out too.
Some niggas.
Yeah, niggas. I'm talking about black people, because white people a lot of times skate.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Like, your boy's out the game.
They be fucking over black people, son. It's a little different from Nate Parker. He got some indies he's trying to do. I remember auditioning for one recently, and it's like,
yeah, going back to that.
I saw his name. I was like, whoa, Nate Parker's still around, huh?
Look at what year it is.
And look how much money he ain't getting.
Boy, he starved when he was eating for a while.
Nigga. But, like, it's just that's the only part of it, because some people is, like, getting mad thinking I'm defending Kevin Hart. I'm like, no, I'm not talking about Kevin Hart. I'm talking about the mentality that's happening son, I'm not the same nigga I was 5 years ago, let alone 10 years ago, and y'all gonna be able to pull shit that nigga might have just humanly forgot existed.
Like, it's nothing what I do now matter.
Bruh, context, please, context.
But what is his context for Kevin Hart?
I ain't talking about Kevin Hart. I'm just saying, watch the mentality. That's it. We need to be aware, because we can see the iceberg coming. Why not try to dodge while we're far enough to see it? That's what I'm just saying. Let's make a note of, yo, in the future, we might not hit a nigga right on the head and be right. Yeah, we might hit a nigga on the head and be wrong, and we might have to listen to, hold up, we might be getting played against each other in the wrong hands, you know. So it's just something I just want to be aware of when we're talking about this topic.
I've had Facebook memories pop up in my feed of posts that I did that I completely forgot I said. Like, woo! I literally don't even remember, like, my thought process.
Some of mine about was embarrassing.
What was going on. Like, some kind of fucking embarrassing things. And I'm like, whoa. Like,
I'm probably going to delete my Twitter.
You cannot, account for, every single thing that you posted unless you really just
and I ain't say nothing bad. I just don't feel like... The thing is, though, I don't... I ain't about to go through all the things I said. Because, Twitter was a space to let out your emotions and feel free for the freedom of speech.
And that was my thing, too, I was talking about online, dog, that kind of fucked me up about it is this is the first time any generation can be documented in a matter that social media does in real time. And at that time, the culture of Twitter was different. Back then, it was more like a diary. It felt more personal.
Right.
It wasn't the same as now. You know to watch yourself now.
Because everybody's on Twitter now. It's such a multi-billion thing. But
back then,
you'd be lucky if anybody was talking back to you.
You ain't think that your boss could get a hold of things. You didn't think that
Twitter get you a job.
Bro, exactly. It wasn't.
Social media can be
the most
weaponized against you.
And that's fucked up how you
kind of became like a porn site after a while because it was Twitter for diary, then Twitter after dark for
It depends on what level of Twitter you was on. But all I'm saying, because Twitter's still Twitter is news. Twitter's just like Facebook now. It's crazy. But what I'm saying is, even if you say Facebook memories, the same shit. I just said some shit. I look back and I'm like, that was kind of misogynistic. You know what I'm saying? That was kind of asshole-ish. And it's like,
take it down either.
Yeah, I ain't because I'm not thinking about it because I'm like you. I'm thinking.
I forgot
even existed. That's why I'm trying to give the human element to why somebody could get fucking caught up in this.
All
shit.
The difference between us and them though is a couple of $100 million.
Nigga, it don't cost no $100 million to get some shit deleted though.
It don't. But I'm just saying
clout.
Right, dog. Because the thing is, we forgot about it and we ain't checking for it because ain't nobody checking for us.
I mean, but even when someone checking for you, you might not think about, you might just think, oh, everything I said was hunky-dory, and then stuff pop up, wait a minute, I don't remember even being, DC, and that's big headspace.
I gotta go on my Twitter and go watch that and see what the fuck I was thinking about back then, and see how far I've grown if it's still there.
But, it's kind of fucked up. It's like, bringing a caveman from the past and then judging him by today's standards. It's like, dog, when you can use the old culture and use the present culture as a means to judge the old culture and get you in trouble presently, that's scary.
I think that's scary.
Also is, though, dog, when you post something up there, when somebody reads it who's never seen it, it's just like you are just now saying it to them in that moment.
Yeah.
No matter when it was dated.
That's what happened to Kevin.
So it always feels like when you said it, it's like you're still saying it.
For the first time.
And you're just saying it now.
Yeah.
And that's also this kind of psychosis thing that kind of makes this whole thing not questionable, but you just have to peep that part of it.
You gotta peep that part of it. That's all. Because the thing is, nigga, Joe was saying from what we were saying last night off mic about your receipts will hold you down. You know what I mean? Like, if you, in the meantime, since then, have been given, have been speaking up for, have been doing the work, have been whatever you do, you know what I'm saying? And somebody, if you got receipts, if someone could vouch to be like, well, because that's what's even happening, because what's fucked up is this.
Another Twitter message in 2012 that said LGBTQ rights need to be blah, blah, blah.
But here go a caveat, son. There are people speaking up for James Gunn, he still got fired.
Well, the thing's, son, he was dealing with, that was white on white power.
White on white power.
And when you was dealing with that kind of clash, dog, they knew how to take him out. All right, so it was bigger than James Dunn. They knew how to take him out.
I'm just gonna say what we all been saying. We just gotta hold yourself accountable when that fire come, and don't leave with your pride because your pride will get you fucked up.
Especially if you're black man, you know.
It's black men are successful. You gotten too high up to not.
Took a fall in this little trap.
Yeah, don't boom. So next thing, and we didn't speak on how Don Lemon invited Kevin Hart to come on his show. Kevin Hart isn't responding yet.
Don Lemon's like, look, bro, I'm giving you a chance, brother. Speak of how you won't be an ally to the LGBTQ community,
trust me, because I know I was in the closet for a long time.
Don Lemon has
done the work. I can show you how to do the work now.
He's become the most, I love Don Lemon.
He wouldn't have said that about 5 years ago.
Right,
niggas,
I hate
that. Ooh, he was a coon. But anyway, Cardi B and Offset split.
Yeah.
The y'all one.
Hashtag. I thought that was funny. I was like, that's what any niggas gonna say, boy. It's y'all fault. Y'all cheated. It's y'all fault, my baby mama side chick or whoever she was on TMZ. They asked for forgiveness.
No, bro, everybody whooping that, y'all what?
Y'all want us to break up. No, bitch, nobody wants y'all to break up. Nobody wants celebrity couples to break up.
For people that don't know, obviously, after Cardi B went on Instagram and announced the breakup and announced he must have fallen out of love, et cetera, et cetera, he wrote under that post, y'all won. And Twitter took that today. Now it's become the, it's hilarious. Like Michelle just broke up with her white man, Michelle Williams.
Her pastor.
And they blabbery put up, y'all won. Michelle Williams and such broke up. they're using the y'all won. Not, y'all,
y'all
won.
Really? You broke y'all up?
Oh, right. God.
Yeah,
you fucked the law. And
and there's these rumors about they didn't have a prenup, so he might have like a stake in her dealings because, her shit started popping after they were married. Like, up with, like,
I don't think I'll say gonna get
that's
down
not
like
gonna
that.
Fly. No,
yeah,
I'm
that,
not gonna get down
it's,
like that.
It's the talk, is all I'm saying.
Yeah,
it's
that
the,
is the talk.
It's the talk.
That too. I don't
that's a little tea because the tea always gotta be hot.
Because
the tea has to be hot. But I mean, honestly, son, like, I knew that marriage was not gonna last. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, I felt like it was a stunt from the jump.
I felt like it was kind of a stunt. Like, maybe there was a little bit of truth in it.
I don't think it was a stunt. I don't think it was a stunt. I think, honestly, I think they actually dug each other, but they wasn't in love. They thought it was love. You know what I mean?
Yeah, like I just think because
she was the hot chick, he was the hot dude. I think they fell in love with that.
Both young.
We five hot motherfuckers. Let's click up together. That's why I don't think they intended it to be a stunt.
And I don't think they was intended.
They just, no. I don't think that's what
it
is.
It was just hollow. It was hollow.
Yeah, they didn't have the foundations in check.
You know what I'm saying? It was just kind of like a hype thing that worked. You know? And, you know. But, I'm not mad at him, you know.
I could imagine it, though. Imagine you hot, and then somebody else says hot. Y'all just click, let's and it's popping, and be hot together.
Yeah, doing
boy,
it.
Boy, put that offset pipe on you.
Yeah, man.
And then you got pregnant.
I mean, she put that Cardi B Bodussi on that ass.
Yeah, right.
Man.
Fine.
She fine.
He got
engaged. He didn't have to produce that ring, nigga. That pussy was
right. That nigga did it on stage. That boy said, you know what? I'm going to go drop this knee right here for that pussy.
But what that pussy?
You know what I'm saying?
My nigga. So, peep the side chick out here crying, trying to get attention and shit.
Man,
I'm like, girl, she just need to shut the fuck up or they beat you up.
Upset since he's had his baby.
Do we have to watch this?
I didn't know how serious this marriage was.
Why do we care? Why do we care?
I kind of see things, but I haven't.
That should be the new one. I know how serious this marriage was. You get cut.
I was just like, fuck
that.
I just saw it on TV when he engaged her, and then I saw the wedding and all
I thought it was a stunt. She thought it was a stunt.
Right.
I thought it was that TV Hollywood shit again.
You know, I didn't know that it was a ring. I didn't know it was married.
I thought they was just playing.
I thought the kid was just,
you know what I'm saying?
Hey, an actor baby.
Right. It was rap celebrity, you know, weddings. You know?
What killed me about it is she apologized to Cardi B. Bitch, get boxed. I wish a nigga would fuck my wife and then come apologize to me online.
Martin, yeah, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I never knew. I thought y'all were married. I know you was a husband. Man. That reminds me of the episode of Real.
Real with the barber. Fuck this bitch.
And that man talked, trying to confront that man. But the man talked that boy into some common sense, and he was also a nigga he couldn't beat up.
I mean, yeah, that too. But yeah. But Real had heart. Rel was about trying to fight him. Because that was a Larry shot ever when you walk in the door and it looked like about level high. Then you step down and you see, oh, this nigga big.
Whoa, Rel. Sit down in that barber chair and just talk it out with this man.
But at least Rel, the barber, was at least saying where Rel fucked up at.
Right.
Imagine you wasn't fucked up, fucking up, so you thought. And then the nigga is fucking your old lady that you thought you was being good to and apologizing. I'm going to fight even more now. You sensationalize this shit. We didn't even know the bitch. Like, we didn't know it was about a chick. We just knew they broke up. We could speculate, but we ain't know. You come in here confirming it, saying, yeah, it was me. It was me. It was me and my pussy.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Sorry. We're sorry.
We're sorry. If I'd have known it was serious, I wouldn't have fucked him in that manner. It would have been less.
I wouldn't have put this shit on him.
So I just would have just given some head. You know, Cardi, this some head. Fuck out of here, man.
But hey. Hope y'all work it out as parents and co-parents. Y'all still part of the blood gang.
For the child's sake, I hope y'all work it out for the kid.
And hopefully y'all have a song.
Pause, Joe, shut the fuck up. Pause. This nigga Joe just said, and y'all both still part of the blood gang.
Not for a second since you were talking about family. I was like, yeah, because, you know, y'all got a kid together. They share y'all blood. Then I realized, no, this is Joseph. He talking about the bloods, for real. The actual bloods. Y'all both still part of me. Y'all still bloods. Y'all can't be beefing.
Right, right. I mean, that's what family's family. But y'all still blood gang.
Sue.
Right?
Oh,
and don't y'all ever forget that.
Oh, my God.
You know what I'm saying? But in the same token, man, good luck to both of y'all careers. I hope y'all come out with a song pretty soon.
What this way, why the song?
Because it'd be fun. Fuck y'all parents. Y'all still can show y'all still working out. Y'all still rapping together.
Yeah.
I got a back, even though I still fucking behind her back.
Now, oh, no. That's not what needs to be on the song. All right,
that's not what's on the song. All right. Give me that remake, though.
500K, right?
Right, I need that.
That's the rumor.
And you know what? You can't talk to Ellen no more. Because Ellen was my friend. I introduced you to Ellen and Cardi B. All right? She was cool with Offset. Not with Cardi B.
She's a bigger star now.
No matter. Ella's my friend.
Boys, there's these white ladies on this white TV show drop Cardi B name. And I was like, oh, you're there now. They're putting you in TV show dialogue with white people.
Yeah.
Okay, Cardi B.
I mean, she's also getting mentioned around to do like...
She got Book of Grammy nomination too.
Yeah, which... Oh, by the way, Nicki Minaj got none. All right, 18 nomination submissions. None of them went through. 18. Ooh. All right. I guess you don't have good form.
Ooh. They said Twitter was lighting her ass up with the memes.
And for having Meek Mill to do a song with Cardi B, which that album was dope.
I still didn't listen to it. Yeah, dope. Man. I'm going to listen to Championships.
I like it.
Everybody been saying great things about it. Like, no one has said anything bad about that whole album. So I believe it. I just got to sit with it. You know what I'm saying? But I got to remember.
Him and Drake got a song.
We know that. We talked about that. Joe, stop smoking.
Oh, my God.
Goddamn.
Oh, my God.
We had a conversation.
In the same context, too. Like, dude, you called this song.
Right?
No.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, God.
Oh, yeah. We did talk about this.
This moment was brought to you by the letter P. For pot. And W. You know what that's for. Anyway, Keith Stanfield praises black women and immediately draws criticism from the keyboard warriors.
Because, man. That's what's going to happen. What about standard.
White chicks?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
That's standard.
Lame, standard, textbook. Bye, internet.
Yeah.
Bye, dog. Right. Come up with something new, man.
Come on, man.
Like, under this beautiful image of the Smiths.
Of the family.
Of the family. Not even his family, but no, Jada Pinkett Smith, her daughter, and her mother. And it is a beautiful picture.
It is. Pinkets.
He wrote, the most beautiful beings I've ever seen, period, black women. The post garnered 33,000 likes, with several comments praising the actor for his support. While most of the comments were in support of his statement, there were the usual keyboard warriors who took the time to ask, what about us?
What about us?
Thank you for the white woman, one remark read. Could have picked some different women, but okay. White women are more attractive. I said what I said. Is that racist?
Okay, this is really getting out of hand.
Why do they always make it racist?
Son, right. They're always going to make it. They're always going to do this shit, son. Like,
number one, women, for the most part that I understand, are very catty. So, bitches be petty anyway.
But what are these women? That was just dudes and women, you know.
Well, I thought we were talking about women for this moment, because if there's dudes on there, I'll get on that ass later.
Yeah, it was both. It's men and women. All right, so that was replying. I'm saying that's even whacker. You sitting up here calling.
If a dude's on there, then a dude is just
whack.
He might be a little feminine.
And racist. Sometimes racism knows no bounds.
No, racism does know no bounds.
They probably wouldn't have even went to that picture if they didn't hear Lakeith Stanfield say something about black women.
That was the trial.
How dare you disrespect my white queen? My...
They don't even call them
European
queens.
European Thor goddess.
I've never heard a white man call a white woman his queen. Nope. Even though it's kind of weird to my ears still, even as a black person, I'm just realizing I ain't never heard a white man
call his woman no queen.
What the fuck you mean?
As much as they're into that culture.
The queen of Scotland, you mean?
The queen of North Scotia?
And of course, not all white people, son, but we're saying this particular type that trolls on the goddamn keyboards that hide behind that shit, that for whatever reason can't leave well enough the damn alone, dog. Like... That man's bigging up these women. He's talking about from his experience. As a black man, I'm going to talk from my experience. My mama black, so you ain't going to tell me not to say black women are beautiful. Fuck you, man.
I'm not going to get mad if you posted three lineages of white women that you thought were beautiful and be like, man, these stupid right here. White women.
But then you can't. But you can't. Stop.
This is a word you
But we, and you can't take the context out that though all black imagery, male and female, were pronounced and presumed ugly for decades in the media by white people. So any restoration of our self-esteem as a community should not be met with any type of fucking backlash. Because if don't let me get famous, I'm going to be saying black, bliggity black, and y'all going to just be mad. I'm sorry. You ain't look like that. Came for LeBron about this same shit. Y'all making this a thing now. Nigga, made me be like, hey, more black niggas. Let's all just big up black shit right quick at the same time. Make them mad.
Son, I'm going to go with a meeting with Maxine Waters on my face. like mask. Word. And be like, what's ham?
Word.
What you want to talk about?
Word. Get that shit trending. We need Maxine
Waters. Who's there with a whole face? Meeting. Her whole face.
Every meeting. That should be standard. I want to kind of come on a fucking stick.
You just pull it
pull
up.
That bitch up. That's boss.
Balls.
Like that.
I'm with it. Big ups to Janelle Monae, NPR. Named her album as the album of the year.
No, that's the nomination she got nominated for, right? Or did she win it?
NPR states that they made a whole article give her a look. It's NPR. They're not like the awards giving. That's just,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They gave her an award, but it's not like.
I thought she got nominated. I read she got nominated.
I thought they just announced that shit. Let me get to it real quick. Because they announced that they felt that was it, and she even replied to, and they named it. NPR named them. His name was Janelle Monae's album, Dirty Computer, the top album 2018. The National Radio Outlet released his rank of the top 50 albums of the year on Tuesday, putting the pop star's April release at the top of his list. Yeah, they named it as that.
Right.
That's what I'm saying. They that's more news and shit. They're not like the Oscars or the Emmys or some shit like that. So that's pretty cool because that album was legit as fuck, yo. Like,
I didn't listen to it.
Oh,
it was,
man.
Dope. The visuals were dope.
We never even showed you the movie?
I saw that. I just didn't listen to the album.
It was essentially that.
It was pretty
but
with, cool.
But a couple of songs gonna be a little soulful, different because it's the album version.
Okay.
It was cool.
It was very
cool.
It was very dope. It was the concept of it. It was about if I had to put it all in one sentence, be the pussy.
Be the pussy.
All right. You heard it first here on Wild Bats Podcast.
Be the pussy. Be the pussy, y'all. Just be the pussy. Investigators, teen tried to scam state out of $20 million with online business, and I'm inclined to not even be mad at this moment.
I'm not.
A hustle's a hustle, son. You got caught. That's the only thing that's bad. You should have been better. But it's all right. You tried it.
Yeah, you went for
now, maybe you can find a way to get into school because you're really good at this shit and some kind of computer technology and mathematics.
I mean, if you only use your powers for good, homie, you probably could have flipped some real shit, dog.
I mean, hell, dog.
His name is Charles Turner, 18. He completed fraudulent transactions that ranged from 14 to 28 mil, telling Channel 2 Action News. There's a total of 28 million sitting in the Georgia Department of Revenue. This nigga pulled it off. Caught him.
You need to be working with the government, son. At 18, you figuring out how to fraud that much money?
Damn.
I wonder how he fucking did it.
Need a job, son.
He had a whole check coming through from them, and then they just caught it. Goddamn.
Crazy.
According to agents, he established an online electronics business. Riverdale X was designed to sell Amazon products for an upcharge, but investigators said all customers got in exchange was compromised bank accounts. Oh, he just was getting them any money. He told us that he was using a website that would collect payment information and that he was able to get the routing, account, and banking information from the website and use that information to make payments to us, along with his car payment and other payments. My nigga.
Ooh, I respect you, Vanessa.
He was swindling. Vanessa. Like, I can't say the respect ain't the word I think I want to use.
I respect the technique. There's one more.
Yeah.
I
respect the technique and audacity, but you fucked them people over.
Yeah, I mean, yeah.
That's all.
You a criminal. You know what I'm saying?
But damn, if you would've.
But boy, you Ocean's 11 ass nigga, you.
Great nigga.
Nigga. As black, little black ATO.
Hope they see potential in you and put you in somewhere where you could, like, do good.
Y'all hear about Layla Lee hitting an old person with a car?
Damn, why? It was an accident?
Yeah, dog.
It happens.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, she didn't just say, I'm going at him.
I thought she was first about to say hit her with a fist. Because, you know, I was like, what the?
Which one would be worse?
Her car, because it's much stronger than her fist.
Nigga, we already learned one punch could kill you, too.
But that's another thing, too. Her hands are deadly.
Bro, weapons.
You know what I'm saying?
Atlanta, apparently. Yeah, I wouldn't want to fight in either. I ain't fighting Layla. You got to pay me some real money.
You can't pay me to lose?
Mm.
You gonna pay me to lose? Because that's what I'm about to do.
Instant.
Like, my nigga, she's a trained boxer.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? For 15 rounds.
Yeah, she hit
her father's Muhammad Ali.
Yeah. And she hit you the right way.
You know who my father is? I don't know. And you'll fuck up Muhammad Ali, man. Fuck, I got a gun.
Mm-mm. All right? Just don't put me in that position.
I got bricks in my boxing glove.
Just don't put me in that position. I ain't trying to fight her. I'm fuck that. The CDC compares Atlanta's AIDS epidemic to that of a third world country. Downtown Atlanta is as bad as Zimbabwe.
Gotta control all that fucking. That's gotta put scary. Them condoms. That's use that preparation. Scary, that prep. Yeah. Use that prep. I like
it. Oh my God, that's scary. I wouldn't I fuck me like one chick I'm in saying, Atlanta, no, boy. I'm scared
to have sex in
nigga, I would be afraid. You said Atlanta, like
as bad as an African country,
nigga.
Holy shit!
One of the most metropolitan cities in the country right now.
If it's an epidemic, that of a third world country.
That's like
bad as Zimbabwe. Oh,
what's the ratio? Is it like one in fucking three people got fucking HIV?
The picture they use in this article, this bad. I'm
saying, I should not have fucked up. I can't believe I knew this bitch had something. Ooh, that's what that shit says. I knew she had something.
I'm hurt for you, dog. Even though you probably just an actor, dog.
Like, I was that horny. What the fuck?
Oh, God.
That's horrible. Throw
the whole dick away.
Oh, my God. Well, you'll have to these days. Like, it's not
like
the 90s.
Yeah, no, you got to. You're right. Actually, you know what? You know what? That's prep. Yeah, and
but you gotta get that before you get AIDS.
Like, no, you get that after you get AIDS too.
I mean, it keeps you from giving it to somebody after you have it.
Oh, it keeps you from passing it on.
Yeah, if you stick on your prep, you can't pass it.
How about let's just not get AIDS?
Yeah, I mean, protect yourself, check your status. But like, you know,
there's also HIV.
I do understand that they're talking about how we need to stop shaming certain shit because niggas ain't dying like they used to. Because like now, a lot of people still,
like niggas dropping like flies.
I'm conditioned off of that shit, though. Like,
dog, that shit was an epidemic, son.
Yeah,
niggas was dropping like by the fucking dog everywhere, dog. That's something real in the niggas' heads, though. Niggas will never forget that.
Yeah, it was a different time, and the time isn't like that.
But now a nigga got a lot of things. But the thing is, we gotta educate.
Yeah, educate.
You gotta educate more about what's going on.
So, again, of course, I'm not saying go out there and get some AIDS, everybody, but what I'm saying is.
HIV,
exactly. Two different things. But it's not the death sentence that it once was, and you know, it'll be irresponsible to present it as if it were.
Cancer is more of the deadliest things these days. Which, are we gonna talk about that guy with that lung thing?
What lung thing?
Oh, y'all didn't hear about that?
It was coughed out that shit? Yeah, I read the headline, but I didn't read the details. That shit scared the fuck out of me.
Some part of said that was a piece of his lung.
Yeah, and it was, and he coughed it out at like a restaurant or something. I just read the headline. I was like,
I literally coughed up a lung.
Nigga, literally. They had the picture of it. You hear me?
Oh, that's so disgusting, dog.
Like, that's intense.
He died.
I can imagine he did. Of course he fucking died.
So, HIV in Atlanta, southern states constitute 52% of all new HIV diagnoses in the United States. The center also found that flat in 2015, the South accounted for approximately 46% of all individuals living with HIV.
Oh my God.
While the disease impacts most demographics of the American population today, they specify that HIV primarily affects Black Americans with inadequate access to health care. In the Peach State, the likelihood of contracting the diagnosis jumps from one person to 51 people. We should not be having an epidemic of that proportion in a country like ours, said Dr. Del Rio. Christian Dawkins, a youth HIV policy advisor, spoke with the Atlanta Journal-Constitution. What he said? Attribute to growing up a patient diagnosis to a lack of acceptance of homosexuality from religious-based families, causing gay residents of Atlanta to live their lives in secret. When you're hiding something, you're less prone to go out and be more careful, if you will. Damn, Atlanta.
Yeah, right.
Like, damn.
That sucks, because they got a lot of beautiful women in fucking ATL.
Oh my God, yes,
like,
they do.
Like, a lot.
Yes, they do.
Damn, that sucks. I'd be so scared. Well, I mean, no, just youth protection.
But it's I mean, real talk, I'm going to have a serious moment right now. I've been thinking about a lot as far as, like, dealing with a partner. Right now, I'm dealing with the same partner, so things are Gucci. But as far as, like, dealing with new people, before I have sex, I do want to, like make it a place where can we go to the clinic? That's a thing to do. Because this is an epidemic in Atlanta, you know what I'm saying? I'm talking about third world countries. And niggas, especially a lot, I know with niggas, don't really go to the hospital and get their status checked and don't even think about it when it comes to like fucking with a chick off the dump as the first thing before they catch something.
Me and D just had this conversation. We go get checked like regularly.
They get checked.
Yeah, they got a spot go to on
I mean,
bro.
Of course, it's not my niggas always with us.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I'll be honest with you. Like, if you just had this combo.
You know what I'm saying? We get checked, you know what I'm saying? I can get blood, nigga. I know this.
But I totally understand what you're saying, though. You and your partner, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like.
Going, stepping in this together, and there's like a fear there for a lot of couples because, generally speaking, most people don't know their status. Yeah.
And before sex, do that as a date, do that as something, you know what I'm saying?
People, I don't know about a date.
You want to go get checked together?
I mean, it ain't got to be a date, but you know what I'm saying? You got like, you know, go do that before you have sex. Go, you know your status together. Feel comfortable to have sex.
That should be
once I know you're good and I'm good, though. I'm going in raw.
Nah! Oh, God, he's just going to give him a bunch of babies. Like you said, do what you said about the shitters.
Like,
you see D-Mac didn't say that when I said that.
That's because, I mean, I kind of agree with you. But I mean, you know, I actually do.
Some clean sex right here.
You know, we got some nice clean sex. I know anybody catch none, then fuck that condom. Because my pullout game is A1, bitch. A1. Never fuck, But in all sincerity, though, like, I think it should be a regular practice. Like, if you start dating somebody new, you should be able to ask them to go get checked and it not be, like, offensive or you're trying to say you feel like they got something or, like, I think that should be regular.
Don't test shame.
Yeah, like, you shouldn't test shame people and people shouldn't be offended if you ask them to get tested.
Right. Don't status shame.
But also, and also on top of everything, educate yourself on the diseases because, once again, there's a lot of stigmas that scaring people that, if you find out more information, it's not as bad as the media and the propaganda is presenting.
Because you'll Google if your elbow hurt, and next thing you know, you're going to die in 3 weeks.
In 3 weeks. And then you go talk to your doctor, and they like, my nigga, boom, 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 boom. So, you know, education. Now, I don't want to leave the starter section just out on talking about AIDS, so I just threw this other random story. I mean, it's just like, damn, that's...
Agreed.
Come on.
Agreed.
But with all the spots like Michigan is made weed legal and such, Oregon is trying to make shrooms legal.
All right, Oregon, you need to chill the fuck out. All right, hold on, sorry, we ain't got the whole 50 states full of weed yet.
Right,
and you trying to come out with some shrooms? Chill out, Oregon.
Calm down, Oregon.
Chill the fuck out. Damn. Calm
down, dog. Dog, I wish y'all could see Alpha Joe's face right now, son. He is absolutely serious.
I agree.
He said, nigga, we ain't get the whole 50 states full of weed.
I'm about to say, we ain't got the weed
Let's
shit
get the weed
down
in the
yet.
Bag. Let's get the weed in the bag first.
Right. See, bro, y'all trying to get us canceled, dog.
You know?
The government like, oh, no, oh, what's next? Cocaine and heroin, huh? Fuck out of here, man.
One thing at a time.
It's slippery slope.
Right, dog.
Slippery slope.
You know what I mean? Uh-uh, dog.
We don't let this weed in. See these country motherfuckers try to get some shrooms in the coke.
Shrooms, nigga?
They gonna try to give our babies meth. Don't legalize the weed.
Right.
Right.
Tell them get a beer like a regular American. Get
nobody,
a beer.
Because beer doesn't
nobody
think
about this? Because the weed's legal.
There, you see what the minds of the young is doing?
They get high, they want to get higher.
I've been drinking a fifth of whiskey every day in my entire life. I never killed not one person.
Hold on, that's a lie.
But now this weed head people trying to make meth legal. You heard
said
them.
You drink a fifth of whiskey, you didn't kill somebody. Like, every day of your life?
Somebody is
you
dead.
Just don't remember it. Because you're drunk.
You don't remember, dog. You done fucking buried a corpse some fucking way.
With your drunk ass.
It's scary to think about it. If you got so drunk, you buried somebody. And you never remembered that you
alcohol
did.
Do you understand
possible.
What a fifth of whiskey is, my nigga?
Oh, God, no. That was part of the joke.
Every day?
He got it so serious. He got so serious about it.
Boy, I think you a murderer.
You're a murderer. You have to be.
You're a drunk murderer. You don't know, man. You wake up every morning. I don't know what the fuck
this
you did.
This nigga went from laughing and was like, wait, now, hold on now. What, now one fifth?
You ain't about to play with this weed now with this drink. I would not let alcohol override weed. Weed is a good thing. And alcohol need to be not prohibition,
oh,
but
God.
Raised up to 23.
You think it should be? For real?
Real talk, son.
They should raise the drinking age?
Dog, drinking.
Interesting. I never thought about that. Why so?
Because drinking, dog, is like, it is maturity, dog. And the thing is, at 21, I seen so much people don't establish their maturity because they overloaded.
The kids be getting at 18. As soon as you hit college, you're drinking.
You know.
Period. That's what happens.
And that's okay. That's cool. That's cool. Get it how you live.
That's fuck. Cool.
I get weed that ain't sold at the dispensary.
That's cool.
So, you know. You gotta
we say make it harder.
Right. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I think they should make it harder.
Make it harder. I hear you. I've never thought about that. I think I'm with you. I'm got to
think
about it.
I don't think you should start smoking weed.
I mean, it don't affect any of us anyway. So yeah. I get to be a Republican.
That's another reason they
look. I get to be a Republican. Tell you this is what you need to do with your life. So look, I don't have to give a fuck. Making rules right. With motherfuckers that don't shit.
But
don't
at 27, nigga, I know what's best for you because I've been there.
Right. Mm. I already broke the rules, so you don't have to.
So let's get into bats. Nerd out moment.
Yeah. What is going on?
Yeah. Bats. Nerd out moment. Bats nerd out.
Bats nerd out.
So, Black Panther is making history yet again by being the first superhero film to be nominated for Golden Globe's Best Picture Drama Nod. Wow. That's big.
That is very big. I'm very proud of it and very a little questionable about it. Cause like,
Are they like pandering?
Not that they're pandering. What does it say about Disney movies? Are now Disney movies are allowed to be, you know, Oscar worthy?
Well, the thing is, it's not about it being a Disney movie because it's more so a Marvel film. And truthfully, when you talk about comic books, The Dark Knight kind of started this shit.
Did Dark Knight get nominated?
Because so many people wanted The Dark Knight to be included in Best Picture because it was so great and whatnot. That's what made Heath Ledger be able to get the Oscar nomination for Joker and eventually win it. But
he won it for Joker?
Yeah, Heath Ledger won the Oscar for Joker, son.
Damn, that opened the door right there.
Right there. And the movie, the Oscar said, well, we have too many people in this slot. So instead of letting Dark Knight get in that year, the preceding Oscars opened the way for more spots. So the Dark Knight made them have more opportunities for people to get in. So I can't say it's a Disney thing. It's a shit is evolving. And Black Panther made a lot of money and changed culture. You can't ignore
it. And as far as a
whole. And it's not even Oscars. This is the Golden Globes, which is like a rung under the Oscars, too.
If it goes to the Golden Globes, it should go to the Oscars.
It should, but it's not always. Most times it does, but not always.
But is a picture being shot for the whole picture and full through? It was an amazing picture.
It was a great movie.
Like, color schemes, scenes,
it's Lion King.
Locations. And Wakanda, though, with all that technology. It's like Lion King 3000.
Dude. I stand by, you're right. But I stand by, you can't make that much money, be in theaters that long, change the shape culture, be that affecting, and not get no award, at least nominations.
Right. The movie is still out with DVD.
It was too impactful. Like, they would have been almost, like, suspect, like, to fucking ignore that.
It would have been, but like, I still wouldn't have been shocked.
It broke so many records, dog.
No, I wouldn't have been shocked, but
we dressed up for it.
I mean, most people did. And like you said, they go record after record. And this is not like Avengers brings in everyone. No, this is one character's first film.
That first film will take Avengers now to the next level that it didn't go before.
Feel me? So it's great that this happened. I'm happy to hear this happening for Ryan Coogler. And, you know, it's a step in a cool direction. Because at this point, comic films are part of our zeitgeist. Mm-hmm. They might as well have their own rung of genre at this point.
Yep.
They probably should have at some point. They've been going strong since we've been alive and since we've been adults. They've been the marquee.
Right.
The straight up marquee, son. So, yeah, man, big up to the Black Panthers.
Big up to the Black Panthers.
Never take away from them.
But we mean the movie.
Hey, did we all catch the Avengers teaser?
No, give it to me. Hit me with it.
Because I did catch that Mortal Kombat teaser.
Oh, we're going to get into that. Mortal Kombat!
That is not how the song
yes,
starts.
Yes, it do. Okay.
Oh yeah,
stay on.
Hey, Miss Potts.
If you find this recording, don't feel bad about this. Part of the journey is the end. Just with the record being adrift in space with zero promise of rescue is more fun than it sounds. Food and water ran out. 4 days ago. Oxygen will run out tomorrow morning. That'll be it. When I drift off, I will dream about you. It's always you.
Thanos did exactly what he said he was going to do. He wiped out 50% of all living creatures.
We lost, all of us. You lost friends. You lost family. We lost a part of ourselves. This is the fight of our lives.
This is gonna work, Steve.
I know it is. Because I don't know what I'm gonna do if it doesn't.
This is Scott Lang. We met a few years ago at the airport in Germany. I got really big.
Is this an old message?
Ant-Man, I know you know that.
It's the front door.
That's me. Can you buzz me in?
He made the cut. He's still alive. He
made the cut. Oh my God. Iron Man, no.
This nigga's in space. Jeez, floating, he's about to die.
In space, about to die.
Nigga said Thanos snapped away Captain America beard.
beard was a person all on its own. Had a mind of its own. Here
they
go.
They gave the snap a name now. They call this event the Decimation.
Wow.
Okay.
Half of everything, 50% is really gone. People made a net noted notion that Shuri's missing. If you pause at a certain part of the trailer, you see Shuri's missing, Pete missing, but we know what happened to Pete. So, Mr. Stark, I don't feel so good. But Scott Lang was up there as missing because I still have not seen Ant-Man and the Wasp. But apparently at the end of Ant-Man and the Wasp, he gets lost in the quantum realm and everybody else gets snapped away. So you don't know what happened with him. So if you already saw Ant-Man and the Wasp, when you see him at the end of this clip, you're like, oh, my nigga got out that bitch.
And he always finds out of the quantum realm.
Bruh. And they say in that movie, I got to see that movie ASAP. But they explored that quantum realm shit more so. And, you know what I mean? That might play a part in trying to defeat Thanos. Because, you know, you talking about hopping dimensions when you fuck with that.
Mm-hmm. How you get so small, you hop into a dimension? That's so dope.
Nigga.
Yeah.
Also, what else they were talking about from what I gathered? Oh, that boy Hawkeye, he back because he have a different costume because he take on the character Ronin. Ronin in comics, Hawkeye became Ronin when he was like, fuck everything, he on some ninja shit, life is hard. So the approximation is most likely his family got snapped away and he didn't. Because remember, he decided to be a family man and now he out here looking like hard up. So I'm like, oh, Hawkeye, oh, your people gone. Aww. I made this approximation and it was confirmed recently by the creators, dog. Thor gonna have to fuck up Thanos because technically in Ragnarok they lost like half of all Asgardians because his sister was tripping. Mm-hmm. And they put half of the Asgardians on the ship to go with Thor somewhere, and the other half that was left of the Asgardians went to Earth, to this new Earth spot that his paw had found to make new Asgard. So when Thanos came and got the fucking stone, killed all the Asgardians on that ship, which makes them even further down to like 50% of what they had, because had, you know,
right. So it's already 50-50, so now they're down to.
But then Thanos snapped after that, right, which even so cut them down even more. They're down to 25. They're goddamn endangered species. Thor got to fuck some shit up. Thor got to fuck some shit up.
It's like two or three Asgardians.
Just riding through the ride.
Yeah, it's like, they don't even know who they are in Asgardians. It's like, man, what part of Asgard are you from?
Nigga, you from the West Bank of Asgard. You from the West Bank. You hear me?
See, so I saw a joke that said, Your mom was so fat that Thanos had to snap twice.
Mm-hmm.
I was rolling. I remember that. I was rolling, son.
Now, one thing that's curiously missing from this, it's not even that curious, it's obvious. Captain Marvel, she's not in this. That's why I call it a teaser.
That's what I thought I was going to see.
Because her movie hasn't dropped yet. Her movie dropped in March. After a movie dropped,
you're going to see a whole bunch of clips of her whipping ass, going through shit like
that. Boy, y'all saw that new trailer?
Nope, I ain't seen it yet. Marvel,
no. Oh, God. Okay.
Hit me with it.
I'ma hit you with it, son. We watched it on reviewing that, and I don't mind watching it again because that bitch fire. That bitch fire. I'm like, all right, Cap, we on board with you, Cap.
Let's see. So Skrulls are the bad guys. And you're a Kree, a race of noble warriors?
Heroes. Noble warrior heroes.
Your life began the day it nearly ended. We found you. With no memory, we made you one of us. So you could live longer, stronger, superior. You were reborn.
I keep having these memories. Something in my past is the key to all of this.
You know how to fly this thing?
We'll see.
That's a yes or no question.
Yes.
Like to know what you really are.
I think I had a life here. What aren't you telling me?
You've come a long way, but you're not as strong as you think. This war is just the beginning.
I'm not gonna fight your war. I'm gonna end it.
Aren't you the cutest little thing?
Aren't you cute? And what's your name, huh?
Fury.
What's cute? I'll be back.
I like it.
Yeah, I like it. I like how she looks. She looks dope.
I like that mohawk when that mask come on and shit. That shit look cool.
I like she's the a little blindy for me as far as her acting. But what I'm trying to figure out is
I
want
to see more of it, though. I like it a lot.
What badassery does she possess that she's going to be able to tangle with Thanos?
She a whole cosmic being that can shoot energy and fly and has super strength. Like, she's like, she can tangle. It's like having put her and Thor together and you gonna be working with some shit, dog.
Hopefully the Hulk gets his mind right,
I'm just
thinking
about the fact that this nigga Thanos got the fucking, like, he can bend reality. Like, he got the rings and shit still, though, right?
He burnt it. He ain't got none of that shit.
Okay, so that's useless now.
It's charred. That's why they gotta figure out quantum realms and shit to figure things out, because he snapped and
okay,
it's gone.
So that's just gone.
That'd be gone.
I was trying to figure out because I saw how it was all fucked up in the end.
Now, he's still a badass, like, nigga.
He still got the shit, though.
I mean,
so, like, does it work? Or no,
from what they say so far, at least with the creator, because, you know, the creator saying certain shit and they not saying certain shit, mm-hmm. and they saying certain shit to be spoilery, and it was like, yeah, the glove is charred is what they're saying.
Okay.
Now,
okay.
That don't necessarily mean that the stones are out of, right? You know what I mean? That's still open to.
He gotta go on a trip to get it fixed.
You
so
know?
So this trip is, everybody gonna kick his ass for to get that.
Or maybe
get it
he
fixed.
Don't get it fixed and the stones is just out there and we doing Dragon Ball Z ass shit chasing the stones. You never know, like, how he playing it. Because all we know is that glove is charged. He can't use that bitch. But that
glove, you know what? The stones can still even be there, but the glove is fucked up.
We don't know. They left it open, you feel me?
And this nigga that made the glove, who the fuck would have known it?
But he still has the casing because he can make another, like, you know what I mean? Like,
that was my only question. I was like, how is she gonna fuck up?
But no, Captain Marvel, badass bitch, dog. Like, she's power. Like, you know what I mean? Like, what, it's like I said, it's having a female Hulk, I mean, a female Thor there.
I mean, the motherfucker was flying through space, like, with no suit and shit.
By herself, taking on this army of aliens.
Yeah, so...
You know what I mean?
She's obviously, you know, power mode activate, but...
Say that shit! Say that shit! She is power mode activate, dog.
For sure.
Half Kree, bitch. Like, I'm coming here with y'all type shit, nigga.
Yeah. She will be the most powerful being...
That they got besides Thor.
Thor is a god.
He's a god.
Right.
And she's a whole freaking crazy energy being that's just going to be able to whoop some ass. And you throw all them together.
Without the glove, Thor is just a mad titan, which is very powerful.
I mean, he's going to kick some ass. That's going to be great to see how they play. They're going to have some time travel in this film, apparently. They've been going back to old points. So, they have a lot of shit for Avengers Endgame is what they're talking about. And I'm very curious. Whatever the world is curious to see where this goes, especially when Captain Marvel drops and then we get the real trailer that let us know what's yam.
Yeah.
What's next?
I like it.
Mortal Kombat!
That shit looks
so crazy. Apparently the Mortal Kombat 11 trailer dropped.
That it did.
And, you know.
First of all, I like the little teaser, because there's the regular trailer teaser, and there's the one like where they tell you to check out the full trailer teaser. And that one has like 21 Savage rapping on it and shit.
Yeah, that's the one I saw.
I thought that shit was hilarious.
I thought it was funny.
Now, what's tripping me out is... they announced that Negan about to be in Mortal Kombat. Is he getting put on the last one, or is he about to be in this one?
No, Negan is going to be in Tekken.
That's what I'm going to say. I'm right. I'm wrong. Tekken.
Yeah.
Okay. I remember Negan. This now. Negan from Walking Dead.
Yeah, from Walking Dead.
Oh, yeah. He's going to be in Tekken. Okay. I was left.
But he should be in Mortal Kombat. That's what...
Yeah, like, that's what some people were also saying, that he's better suited for combat. But I'm in Tekken. I like all the little neck people are dead.
My nigga.
I with the drama tag. You a shit top, but we got the money. Tryna fit fight, but you numb for that. You gon' get a bullet in your lung for that. Stupid. Just gon' get it cooking like Luke Kane. F and N on me in a move thing. Glock 19 in the blue flame. I was strapped down inside your boot thing. 21 or more, we'll never die. Loyal to my brother, I never lie. Call me burned out, cause I cheat and I'm fly. And I love winning, I'm upset if it's a tie. If you ever try to go against the game, we gon' drop it.
Oh, give it to him. Give me that kind of fucking food, nigga.
Off the ground just to knock you to the floor. Yeah. Let's go blow for blow. Yeah. Let's go toe to toe. When it's time to battle, they don't never ever show. When it's time to battle, I'm the first one at the door. At the door. Yeah. Here we go.
But just that song was just goofy as fuck to me.
Community reveal, Van Jefferson. The song was so... the song was...
like, they got 21 on that bitch.
Like, you took all the gore out of that bitch and made that bitch, like, real hot to watch. Like, I thought it was about it. Without the music, and just niggas fighting, and the song's like, oh, look at this. But it was like, nah, let's take it up a notch.
Let's cater to the blacks. Let's give them their 21 or whatever the fuck they say these days.
Hip hop run the world.
Dog. I take it, no fucking. That he'll kick the shit out of Scorpion to that fucking 21. Knock his ass down and then I'm back and fly. I was like, yeah.
That's right.
Get that nigga, son. I hope they dance for a second.
So was that looking like an evil Raiden?
Yeah, Raiden got fucked up at the end of the last game. Like, he basically went fucking crazy.
I think I remember this now. Yep.
He like killed.
And they kept it going. Again.
Yes, I guess he's fucking mad Raiden now.
He's mad Raiden. He got the red fucking lightning.
Yeah, red lightning. I was like, oh,
glowing
shit.
Eyes on some okay. Other shit. He on meth now.
Right. Nigga doped up, fucking thumbing niggas' eyes into their skull and shit. Like,
Raiden. Killing all Raiden. Hold up.
Wait, but what's up with these double scorpions, though?
It was the old school and the new school.
Yeah, there was more than one scorpion.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, man.
Like, the first scorpion, like, the first one, like, he's supposed to be dead. But then, like, another one popped up some kind of way.
I thought he got summoned back.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there's by all kind of timeline shit going on with Scorpion and Sub.
But they showed at the end, or Sub all the time, but they showed at the end of this trailer, somebody got this little time stone thing, so it looked like they fucking with time.
Yeah, that's a new character. Apparently, the new storyline is centered around whoever the fuck that is.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, like they're doing some time bending shit or whatever, going back in the story, blah blah blah. So
because you saw it was old Scorpions, a guy at the new Scorpion got fucked. So you know they're showing there's gonna be some time travel.
Yeah,
with whoever that new character is.
Yeah,
I'm here for. I'm always there for some Tekken and some Mortal Kombat. Hell yeah. Those are like my two favorite fighting games for real. No
yeah, doubt. Yep. For mine, I'll say Tekken and Mortal Kombat would be my two favorite as well.
I know you're the Street Fighter king.
I'm Team Street Fighter, but I think after that it's probably Tekken and then Soul Calibur for me. I like Soul.
Soul Calibur is pretty fun.
Yeah, it's fun. It's a fun game.
It's Tekken with weapons.
Yeah.
That's what that is to be, Tekken with weapons.
Bitch. That's what it really is, dog. Them boys be doing some real kung fu ass, weird ass fighting style shit, but with weapons.
With weapons, dog. And last up in Bass Nerd Out Moment, we got a Plastic Man movie about to pop off. The
fuck is Plastic Man?
What does he make?
He a DC character, man.
Plastic cups.
It's like Mr. Fantastic stretch, bro.
How you get your photos about this?
My son said, this is big cat plastic cups. He's just throwing plastic cups at people.
Red cups.
His fucking arch nemesis is Lil Wayne and shit. Trying to collect the fucking cups and make a big cup. God damn it.
That nigga be at the floats and shit.
Nah, man. But he's like one of them like stretchy type niggas. He can stretch. He crack jokes. Right now, I just feel like both companies are just throwing shit at the wall. To be like, what's about to stick?
That's what it smacks up to me. Like,
that's no plastic, man.
Y'all kind of reach.
Son, Marvel just threw they about to have the first Asian superhero with Shang-Chi. And out the blue, now the Shang-Chi shit about to pop. I'm all about to do the Asian superhero cat. Now we got DC saying, well, we're going to do Plastic Man.
Plastic Man.
And then there's also, like, you know what I mean, Birds of Prey coming. And we got the Joker movie. And we got
Styrofoam Man next.
Nigga, I feel like they just digging a Blue Beetle, the Hispanic version they just announced recently, too.
I don't mind
too.
Blue Beetle.
I like him, but I'm just saying, I'm seeing all these announcements of all these different superhero properties on both ends. That
please, something land.
Bruh, they
I'm
both.
I'm trying to land for a 7 or a 6.
Son, they both really are that shit. I'm curious. I mean, I'm here for all the superheroes. Yeah, right. Son. But it's just y'all. Can we get more movies of the classic shits too?
Right.
You know what I mean? But I think that's it, man. That's all I got for Bass Nerd at the moment. That's all I feel like getting into right now. Just a few announcements, a few things going down. Apparently, the next X-Men movie, Dark Phoenix, is coming out soon, and it's the last movie for the Fox and then Disney taking over and shit. But the director said he let Kevin Feige, who runs Marvel, see their script. They'd be like, you know what I mean? Check it out to make sure we ain't making no whack shit. Mm-hmm. Even though, like, Kevin Feige, like, okay, when we acquire them, we're going to change it all up anyway. Yeah. But they say it's years from happening, so that's another reason why he up with that script, because that's going to be the last representation of X-Men, probably for the next 5. So
you know what I'm still pissed off about?
Yeah.
God of War movie that just never happened.
Mm. Apparently that game won Game of the Year.
Yeah, I about to say that game.
Oh, word. Mm-hmm. I mean, it seemed like a decent game, but it just wasn't like the classic God of War style of play that I liked.
Yeah.
So
I want to play it because I heard the storyline was really dope.
That's what somebody on my wall said. They said they don't agree with it being full-blown Game of the Year because they had other games that like did some revolutionary shit.
I don't think they made the final cut at the time.
But they said that the story was fire, so that's probably what made it cool, because they gave the props to the story more so than the game itself. So you know what I mean? I didn't play it, so I don't have no dog in the fight. But I feel you on from playing the old ones. I would have loved to see a movie pop off from that situation.
Yeah,
but as long as they don't fuck it up.
Yeah,
like they always seem
like
to
they seem to always movies. Do with for whatever reason. Video game movies and anime movies, they don't know how to get it together. Like leave them the fuck alone.
What video game movie they ever got right?
So far, people say the closest is the newest Tomb Raider movie was pretty good.
I didn't see it.
And they say it aligned with the newest Tomb Raider games. Like, the newest Tomb Raider games changed up a lot of the lore, and they stuck hard to that.
The first Mortal Kombat was pretty alright.
Yeah, but it wasn't a good movie. It was good for its time. Like, you know, stand the test of time of being a good movie. You could pick it apart. But we love it because, you know, it was kids when it came out. I'm always...
It was just a Mortal Kombat movie.
I'm a ride for it, but I can't call it...
Compared to the second one?
Oh, the second was atrocious.
It was atrocious, but I think I kind of liked it, honestly, because I just enjoyed seeing, like, more characters of the game being in the movie.
Yeah.
That's all I wanted to see. Yeah, man, just...
Shit, nigga turned to a dragon.
I could only watch those films as a kid. Mm-hmm. I only could especially watch part two as a kid. I could watch part one now and be like, look at this shit.
Now the Street Fighter movie was just god awful.
I like that, like, as a kid too.
I only like
a kid, yeah.
But you know that Street Fighter 2 animated film hold up. Yeah, I don't know if y'all have seen
animated
that.
Animated films are dope as fuck. But, and the live action remake that they did recently, it was fucking amazing.
Yeah.
The one by Chun Li or something else?
Nah, though.
With Akuma and shit.
Yeah, like with Akuma and like that whole fucking backstory. It was Ryu online and, only.
Yeah.
But that shit was
It
went hard. Fire.
It was dope. Yeah, so I think D put me on it. Yeah, no, yeah. D did put me on it. We watched that shit, dog.
And it's trippy to me how so many smaller creators, quote unquote, can get it right online and shit. But these big budget motherfuckers can't write a story or shoot it in a manner because, to say they fucking live.
Because most of those big budget companies and groups don't be fans of this shit.
Right.
They just see it as a money-making lick. You know what I'm saying? But when you got like those smaller groups that actually really enjoy like the actual stories of the games and shit and they want to stay true to it, it's always going to be different. Like there's way more passion in it versus just having like bigger pockets and toys and stuff. So... smaller companies always tend to do those type of offshoot game shows better.
I'm afraid for these anime ones, like I said, Cowboy Bebop getting a live action, Avatar from Nickelodeon getting a live action. Cool. There's a few of these joints that's getting a live action that I'm afraid for how they play out. Hopefully they get it together and don't be Death Notes.
Well, yeah, hopefully. Please.
No, just don't Death be Note Death was Notes, a Death Note. It was a Death Note.
It was, exactly. You could just leave it right motherfucking there. Shouts out, this week coming is the Elseworlds crossover event on the CW, dog. They're going to be having a mix-up of, like, on Batwoman. They're going to have Superman, Flash, Arrow, all these shows coming together, and it's about to be fire. And I can't wait to catch that. Anybody listening, Flash is good again. Arrow has been hitting on all cylinders. Like, both those shows, I was like, I'm pleasantly surprised. Cause
you see, stuck in the fight, y'all.
Yeah, because...
seeing the storm.
Because Flash mirrored Arrow, dog. Like, it stumbled for its third and fourth seasons, and now it's at its fifth, and it's going hard. Arrow did the same thing. The third and fourth seasons was, cool. But then season five was amazing. And since then, six, and now it's in the seventh season, is doing this thing. Cool. So, big ups to both those joints. And Black Lightning is still holding on, doing this thing, too. I've been watching Supergirl, though. I still enjoy Black Lightning's. Sexist. Black Lightning's blackness is just amazing. Keep it going. But so
about Supergirl's story never appealed to me. Cause she was just like, I was just like, all right, we get Superman. All you people strong. Fuck, get out of here.
She got different stories. Like, they say that she's going hard. Arcs, I just didn't catch it.
But it's like, the powers are the same.
Yeah, they have the same powers.
That's the thing. It's like, damn, you know, like can you like do something else different than Superman? Like,
they got the same power. Recently in comics, I think they changed some shit up, but I don't know. I don't keep up with Supergirl like that.
Like Super Dog and all that. I don't fuck about all this.
Super Dog.
As Crypto, man. That's
yeah.
Like,
man,
oh, Super I used to Dog. Love Crypto. Crypto Super man. Dog. Crypto. Yeah. That shit's go hard.
Sure did. Joe, man. What's up with some sports, bro?
All right. So the NFL has decided to fine the Dallas Cowboys for that hit
on
Alvin Kamara. I think a $26,000 fine or something like that. But they fined his ass. And people still upset about that. That shit is a very serious thing, that, like, when it comes to head-to-head concussions.
Yeah.
Like, you can't do helmet-to-helmet. And that shit, not only should have been called by the refs, but it should have been a fine. Thank you for NFL for calling that out.
Right.
New discussions comes up with the your boy on, what's that running back that got kicked at the NFL name again?
You asking us?
We talked about him.
Oh, Kareem Hunt?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, he... new things came about how the white woman was calling him all type of niggas and this and the third.
Mm-hmm.
Still, y'all will take responsibility for the actions.
Yeah.
But it's fucked up that that man had to go through, like, he had to get provoked out of a situation like that. He got a character. He probably, you know, sorry you had to lose your cool, brother.
He probably, I think the kicks is what fucked him.
Yeah, specifically. Yeah. The kicks
that,
were exactly
that little back and forth, he probably would have got away with, but when he came back and kicked
him. That kick there is what sealed the deal for
that's
you, buddy.
That's what sealed your deal, homie.
LeBron has taken the team up to another level, you know what I'm saying?
Man, you saw that clip of your boy that kept on knocking the ball out of bounds, and then he eventually got that bitch off some hustle shit.
What?
Like, I don't know these niggas' names, but it was a clip I shared that bitch. I was joked out, dog, with, like, one of their teammates. I was trying to, like, one of their games on the league, because he kept on trying to, like, you do one of the niggas, like, about to pitch it in from the side. And every time a nigga tried to pitch the ball to his teammate, the nigga on the Lakers team, he kept kicking it on accident and not letting it, but kicking it back out of bounds. So they tried like three or four different attempts to put the throw this fucking ball to his teammate. And then the last attempt, I'll be the fourth or the fifth attempt, nigga finally got the ball for real from out them niggas. And LeBron and them bucked up on his side and joked out. Because they're like, damn, nigga, give me that hustle, bitch. And I was like, yeah, bitch, you put that hustle in, homie.
For real.
And then got fouled and got two free shots. Boom.
Man, LeBron is hanging with the West strong right now. What else is going on?
Only LeBron?
I see the whole team stepped up because of LeBron.
Because of LeBron.
I mean, he stepped on that court and everyone's played at a good level. People that was like in the Lakers before he came, they were like supposed to be good, like Alonzo.
Yeah.
Like, he's really stepped up his game as a point guard, really, and fully. And also with Rondo's teaching as well, being there with him. It's been real good. Okay. On top of that, someone wanted to say Allen Iverson. That man gave out his starting five of who he wanted to play. They excluded himself of his like a fantasy basketball team, and that included, of course, LeBron. But I'll go in order: Stephen Curry, because he couldn't include himself. Mm-hmm. So Stephen Curry, Michael Jordan, Kobe Bryant, LeBron, Shaquille.
He would play Shaquille. That's an interesting matchup.
That's his starting five of who he would want.
Oh, you mean as a team?
Yeah.
Okay, I got you. I thought you said he would play one-on-one.
Oh, like, no, he would. No, number one, he done sauced all them niggas.
True that.
He already sauced that whole starting five.
That's funny, he has, because you got that clip of him and Young stepping too, yup. Damn, okay, word. I got some sports shit if you're done.
Hold on, let me see. Oh, yeah, the boxing match with Wilder and...
To this day! To this day!
It became a tie, even though he knocked him down twice. But
I thought Wilder won. And no, people were saying it was suspect that he won.
No, he didn't
win.
Who
did he fight?
He fought that white
some
man
British nigga.
Named Gypsy.
Some British nigga. And he was mad because it felt like America could get behind the white boys just for America's sake. But for the black niggas, they'll jump on some Brit or some Irish nigga's side.
I agree. I saw that shit with the fucking McGregor fight. Like, they was, like, I kind of felt like they was kind of just jumping on just the non-black side. Like, regardless.
And you weren't even black. You're like, Palestine still wasn't white.
It wasn't American.
Yeah, like, it just wasn't, yeah.
And it tends to be in boxing, you ride with America, right?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, and that was one of the things he was mad about. That.
But no, he didn't win. It was a tie.
All right.
And that's why they don't have a rematch later on, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, I think that was a little set up for them to have a tie and have a rematch later on.
And he knocked him down twice?
But the Gypsy, that means that your boy must have had a lot of points in other rounds for him to get knocked down twice.
Yeah.
But the boy, Gypsy, had kind of praised your boy after the fight. Was like basically like thanking him, like giving praise to his hands, like, you know, boy, you got that work.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But the rematch would be brutal. Deontay Wilder gonna kill him.
He gonna try to kill him.
But the intro key was dope because he came out to J-Rock's, you know, black on black on black, black, black.
Real. Cause dude, I felt them on the level of nigga. You are a black reporter asking me what the fuck I mean about black people been fucking having to deal with bullshit in this country for years. Like, dog, you don't ask me that.
Yeah, right. Don't ask me that fucking bullshit.
That's what pissed him off. You had the nerve to be a black nigga asking me what I mean.
I completely get you.
I felt them. I felt them. That. Like nigga, yeah, man. I'd be mad too. God damn it. Indeed. Ask me no shit like that. So also in the realm of sports, man. Brandon Brown gets 8 years. We don't like to claim him as a former Saint, so you know, we're going to say former
Who
Seattle
Brandon,
Seahawk.
Brandon Brown again?
Apparently he wasn't that good, but he didn't murder the motherfucker. He catched it. Or not murder. Well, I forgot what he did. Let me let the story roll on up.
You're a murderer.
I mean,
you do the crime. I
will steadily stand by. If you get legit money and you fuck up, I have no... Like, they set you up is one thing, though. I mean, if you legitimately, nigga, knew you.
I ain't got no fucking sympathy for the
you
bullshit.
You fucked it up, nigga. You ain't get fucked over. I have sympathy for people that get fucked over and set up.
Correct.
But no, son. You out here, you doing stupid shit. And you out, you got it. You made it out. You made the money, dog.
Yep.
I be wanting to fight niggas like that, dog. We out here trying to hustle.
Right, dog.
You got out of the
niggas
cage.
Out here hustle. Cause our pockets be hurt.
I thought you was gonna finish that line, but nigga, you was amped, you jumped in strong. I was like, okay.
I got a damn song, nigga. For every comment passed, there is a song by Alpha Joe.
Brandon Browner was just sentenced to 8 years in state prison after pleading no contest to attempted murder. The former Seattle Seahawks star and original member of the famed Legion of Boom defense was accused of breaking into his ex-girlfriend's apartment in Laverne, California, and allegedly chased her, dragged her, and smothered her in a carpet. Her two children were present when the alleged abuse occurred. Browner was also accused of stealing a woman's Rolex watch. He fled the residence, was later arrested and charged with attempted murder and faced life in prison. On Tuesday, the 34-year-old appeared in court where he pleaded no contest on one count of attempted murder and two counts of willful child endangerment. In exchange, the remaining charges, robbery, burglary, and false imprisonment, were dropped. Browner was immediately remanded into custody during the hearing and is back behind bars. Browner got credit for 300 days for good behavior during the time he spent behind bars so far. He's been in custody since the arrest back in July. He's a former Pro Bowl cornerback and won one Super Bowl with the Seahawks and one with the Patriots.
Oh, yeah, so that nigga, mentioned since the Red Talk, son. He gonna do like 5 years. He got money. He probably paying his way through jail to be straight.
Yeah.
He good. You know what I'm saying? Life is not normal for him, but it ain't too bad.
And that's what sucks, man. Like,
you fucked up, though.
Son, if he wasn't who he was, he would have got way more than the 8. Like, first and foremost, what you say is true. He ain't gonna do them 8. And he would have got way more than them 8 that he's allegedly going to do.
Well, I mean, you know, money dictates
everything.
You know, how real your talk, legal process happens.
I'm gonna everything. Be honest with you, dog. If he didn't have his money, he wouldn't have done 8. Because him, like, not, all he did was drag this black woman. They didn't say like, and I'm gonna say black woman because it's a white woman. He'd have done life.
He dragged her and smothered her in the carpet in front of her children. He'd have done more than 8 years.
Smothered and killed her, right?
No, she didn't die. It was attempted murder. She didn't die.
So like they playing with attempted murder in the sense of like what's smothered and what's not.
That is attempted murder.
In front of her children, experience suspect like 8 years. Somebody ain't that much.
Domestic abuse.
You can say that, but I mean, I think
8 years still ain't enough.
I think an average lawyer could fucking get that as a fucking attempted murder charge.
I don't know. I think an average lawyer can like fight that shit of like domestic abuse.
Why did he stop doing it? He got caught or
no, somebody stopped him? He left and stole the Rolex and got the fuck. We don't have the context of that, do we? Of the whole story of how it went down. Like we had the context that he stole the Rolex and shit.
Attempted murder around the board. In fact, that's what he said. Like, that's what they charged him with.
That's what they tried to charge him with. Oh, that's what he got charged with, but he only going to have to do 8. Now, that's some funny shit. 8 years for attempted murder.
That's gay, yeah.
Nigga, what? That's what I'm saying. That's where that money coming to play to me.
Well, I almost did 10 to L.
Say what?
He almost, like, he 2 years from 10 to L.
I thought you said you did 10. I was like, boy, what? You almost did 10.
In another life.
Yeah, I mean, like, what is this part of the life happening? I wasn't here for a nigga.
That was centuries ago.
centuries long, long ago. Shouts out to Ricky Williams. He announces the Freedom Football League.
Yeah, I want
to
talk about that.
Run by former players, right, including include Terrell Owens.
It's not gonna work. Sorry, it's not gonna work. Y'all don't got the funds. Y'all don't have the clout, son. Y'all don't have the support. It sounds really nice. It's not gonna work, dog. The Freedom, what, the fucking Freedom League? Like, that sound, it's not gonna happen at all. Good try. Good try, dog. Very
the Underground Railroad.
Yeah, like, come on, dog. That's just smacks of Underground Railroad Nigga League football.
The bus boycott.
My nigga said Nigga League football.
Only your mama is gonna support this, homie. Only your mama and your best friend, son.
He said that Nigga League football.
Nigga League is not about to happen.
Nigga had a nigga's on
NLL. That's NLL.
The NLL. That's what I'm talking about.
That's NFL.
Yeah,
nigga league football.
Mm-mm.
Where it goes down in this bitch.
Nigga said the fucking what's it called? The Freedom? The Freedom Football League? The
Freedom,
FFL?
The Freedom Fighters, SNCC.
You know? What which are all great things. Like, I'm not trying to shit on the Freedom Fighters or SNCC. But, dog.
Have it in your football league.
They are not about to let this shit fly.
The man. I Have a Dream Football League.
You might as well have called it that, dog. You might as well would have called him that. Like, I get why y'all need to do this, and somebody does have to fight this fight because the fucking league does suck. Because
we need this fight by any means necessary.
Yeah, like, it does suck in a lot of fucking ways. Like, this is actually really good, but the reality of this shit taking off on the magnitude of the fucking National Football League is, nah, I don't see it's gonna take y'all about 20 years.
Oh my God.
Nah, it's called no fucking Freedom League. That's so, a damn shit.
I'm calling it the Freedom League, too. Yeah.
So
y'all could have called it anything but the Freedom League.
Yeah.
Williams, Terrell Owens, and Simeon Rice are among the names associated with the league. According to Williams, there are about 100 stakeholders with 50 former players among them.
How many stakeholders in the fucking league right now?
I don't know.
Probably like 1,000 or some crazy shit.
You're killing me, son. You're killing me.
The NFL's got,
oh God,
tens of thousands of stock shareholders. We got 100. Come on, dog. It's logistics. I ain't even hating on you, bro. It's logistics, my nigga.
It's that Negro League football.
It's a numbers game. Y'all losing the numbers game.
We even call it Nigga League. Negro League football. Negro League football.
I'm sorry to cut you off, but it's just so preposterous, dog. Like, it's preposterous.
Football gonna be black, red, and green.
Yeah.
The whole ball.
And it's gonna be as big as the National Football
League. Oh, God. Oh my God.
Oh, everybody gonna be tuning to watch that. Everybody.
According to ESPN, games will be in the spring and summer to avoid colliding with the NFL, of course. It will initially be 10 teams. The league's mission statement is to attract football players at their highest level of athletic ability, including those defecting from the NFL, graduating college or high school, or playing in international or alternative professional football leagues. The league's ultimate goal appears to be to allow people to play football who are out of the NFL or even looking to get back into it. The league is to be funded both privately and publicly. So when Williams says it will be partly owned by the players and partly owned by the fans and partly owned by the operators, he means it.
This is like a retribution kind of thing.
So this is like y'all gonna have GoFundMes and stuff.
Negro League football.
This is a grassroots thing. It's not gonna work, dog.
We're trying to.
Nah, it's a grassroots thing.
Shit funded. We all go into it. See? We work together to make it happen. It's not working, son.
We try to develop young men.
How ABC gonna buy that?
Oh my God.
And Fox.
We develop young men. You can't take away their voice and expect them to develop. When I grew up watching football, I really wanted to be like Jim Brown, ironic. Not because of what he did on the field, but because he could take that platform and have a voice. And so when I got to the NFL, expecting that to be the case, anytime a big social issue came up, we were told, be quiet, it's a distraction. And so we're trying to change that conversation.
I feel him on that.
What else?
No. I feel that. I really do. Because they do stifle your voice.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But...
Oh my God. Now, I want to jump to the other side of the field on this. So we have Negro League football. And now we also have Vince McMahon in the NXFL has also come back. They will have 8 teams. They will have a 2020 launch.
A whole 8 teams.
And nigga, look at
Vince. The Negro League got 10 teams.
We have 8 full teams.
Look what Vince McMahon said. He's also expressed his desire to sign players without criminal records. It's like we're talking about the black side. This is the Ku Klux football. Ku Klux football.
Ain't no black people.
He said we want to eliminate the practice of kneeling during the play of national anthem.
Wow.
People don't want social and political issues coming into play when they're trying to be entertained. We want someone who wants to take a knee to do their version of that on their personal time.
Wow.
Vince, you lucky I like wrestling, dog.
Bruh.
Yo, I can respect him being very plain.
At least he's straight up, you know.
Plain with this shit. And fuck all that none of that shit. Yeah, I respect that. That's fine for me.
Not gonna work.
But it's not gonna work, though.
And if XFL is not gonna work.
XFL, 8 teams. Nigga League, 10 teams. Dog, like... son. First of all, y'all don't have enough fucking people participating. You know what I'm saying, dog? How many teams in the fucking league, son?
Forty something.
Oh, so the league got four times the personnel.
Shorter seasons, though. You know, shorter seasons.
Shorter seasons.
Faster games, because XFL specifically said they're never going to stop the clock.
Then it's
they said we're
not. It's not even football. What the fuck is this,
we're not stopping the clock.
All kind of different rules. It's going to be in the fucking summertime and shit. What's the summer sports?
Baseball.
Baseball?
Socks. I think
soccer. Now, the original XFL was some nigga shit. Like, they had, you could have your nickname on the back of your jersey.
Yeah, right.
You could hit a nigga as hard as you want.
There was no rod about it.
That ain't nothing but American Gladiators.
But really, but no, this one's going to be like regular football, except with less teams and more rednecks, apparently, because, you know, we don't want none of that political shit. Take that to the nigga league. You want to take a knee? Go to the nigga league with that high-ass Ricky Williams and all those drug-using and white bitch fucking Terrell Owens.
That's a white bitch fucking
Terrell Owens.
It's just like teams all, that, baby. All that shit just smacks of a game show versus like watching.
The niggas like back into the league of like, maybe like, possibly play football.
Retired?
They have been hurt.
Yeah.
Or, like, let's say you didn't even make it in, like, let's say in college you didn't even make it, like, you know what I'm saying? There's a chance to have, like, another thing to it.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Really? So basically what you're saying is, it's like old niggas, injured niggas, and niggas that couldn't make the fucking cut in the first place.
A man gotta be all that.
That's exactly what the fuck it is, though. Fuck that. That's exactly what the fuck it is.
It gotta be all that.
It ain't gonna work. It can't work.
It could be an alternative.
An alternative to what? So, okay, so we're gonna have niggas like Emmitt Smith, Dan Marino, you know what I'm saying? Nah, Rice, like,
man,
Aaron Brooks gonna be in the fucking league. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, we are really, like, this gonna be big. That's gonna be big. That's gonna be major.
But I don't know who these 10 teams gonna be and what the name's gonna be.
I feel like the XFL name's gonna be the goofiest ones, because remember what they old
the Terminator.
Right.
Extinguisher.
Nicknames on the back of
they
the
got
fucking
pledge
jersey.
Names and shit.
Son, what? I don't think we need four different leagues.
We don't.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that's going to be, like, it's just convoluted.
Who's this going to be sponsored by? It's going to be sponsored by, like, fucking, like...
RC Cola.
You know, yeah, like, RC Cola, fucking Mr. Pibb, you know, fucking...
Mr. Pibb!
Like, shit like that, dude. Like, it's just, I don't know. Like,
they
I
say,
see,
give us your broken toys and we gonna make magic.
It's going to be the League of Misfit Toys, huh? Like, nope, bruh. Nobody's gonna sponsor this shit. Like, I see what they're trying to do. Like, it sounds great on paper.
Is it gonna come out on TV? That's what I'm wondering. Like, where does this come on? Like,
if they're ambitious enough to try to get it on TV, I think that's where they're gonna shoot themselves in the foot for the eighth time with that project. Cause, like, I think it would do better, like, on like a streaming service.
You mean XFL or Nigga League?
Nigga Leagues and the XFL. They should not try to get, like, on any sort of, like, syndicated television.
XFL gonna be on the WWE network.
I mean, we know that's for a given, but I don't think he gonna just depend on people to just watch it on the network. He gonna most likely try to get some deal somewhere, like how, you know, yeah, USA play Raw.
Boy, if you don't get the fuck out of that Vince, you gonna lose another billion.
Maybe. Might be on Fox.
Nah.
Like when NFL ain't happening.
Fox Sports?
Because Fox Sports.
Not that shit
Fox
play.
Sports bought.
They two sports now.
They bought SmackDown, though. SmackDown about
SmackDown,
to be on Fox Sports.
The thing about SmackDown and wrestling is different.
Yeah, that's way bigger.
It's its own entity.
Mm-hmm.
NFL and something XFL, which is very related, is not going to fly by as sports. Like, it won't be mentioned to as a serious thing as the rest of other sports.
As I was saying earlier, like, it just really comes off as a fucking game show.
A gimmick.
Or like it's a gimmick. It just comes off as really gimmicky. And while that can be still entertaining to watch, because it can... I don't know. It's a little bit weird for me right now. I don't think it's gonna fucking work.
The thing with the Negro Leagues is that it's gonna be like real, like regular football, and I think that'll be on the NFL. But
I think they both are. XFL is trying to be like regular football.
I just something about XFL, like, I don't know.
It's never going to be regular football.
Both of them are essentially trying to do the same thing, but catering to two different audiences.
I think the other one, I think the Negro Leagues will have a better chance if they just change the name from Freedom Football.
Yeah, they can't go with that, with like, that fucking they could be
with another name, they could be looking like, all right, let's just check on what the, you know, old people in their time are still doing. Because I like to watch the niggas see if they still got it. And
I mean, but it's not just retired like people. It's going to be like new hot niggas that didn't get
fantasy,
a shot.
It's going to be fantasy football, basically.
You know what I mean?
Kind of like fantasy football. Niggas that's not in the league, they can play this football league.
It's a mixture. It's going to be like, they say, Canadian Football League. Niggas like all these motherfuckers that's just not in the major leagues that decent, you know. They're going to have this shot, and it could be entertaining depending upon how it's played.
Yeah.
And XFL specifically saying that they want to, like, you know what I mean, increase their thing to be more like fantasy type shit. I don't know what they're trying to do, but it's like
the watch. Have like storylines and stuff.
They didn't say nothing about storylines. They meant like how people play fantasy.
Storylines, that shit be crazy, man.
But that's what they tried with XFL, and they saw it fail. So that's they trying to, that's why I'm saying they're trying to walk the line. But that's what made me look at the situation of, if you don't make nothing somewhat different, what's the point? It's just small football. Smaller football.
The thing about XFL is that it's ran by too much of a hard dictatorship of a nigga's already like too patriotic in the game of control.
They both gonna play to the audiences. There's gonna be some redneck niggas gonna be watching that shit.
And the other ones just sound like a bunch of old niggas and like that, I always say reaching like, but you know, just like it seems like it's more of a mixture in the Negro Leagues than it is in the fucking XFL. The XFL seem a lot more whites only club.
They gonna get black people because niggas gonna want that check. And you know how poor people love, bro.
Whites only club.
Feel me?
With those black people, they white too.
He said they white too. All right, let's get up out here, man. I ain't got no question of the day this week. Again, hit us up at flywithbats@gmail.com. If y'all want to talk on Ask, help us out there. You feel me?
Hey, man, if I go ask y'all to fuck in a confessional, what y'all doing?
Wait, what?
In a confessional like priest?
Mm-hmm.
I've been to confession before, but that was when I was younger and not as fucking evil.
Shit, I'm not Catholic, probably.
I forgot what you said. D-Mac, bring me out in the confessional. Give me something to send up and to confess about. You had to serve her duty?
I've done a lot of nasty things in the church before.
Absolutely, son. I would never pass up the opportunity to have sex in a confessional. I would never pass that up. Like, I've just never met a chick that's metal like that. You know what I'm saying? But if it was offered to me, like, I would not hesitate. Like, it would have to happen.
Yeah.
I would have to.
I'd smash a chick in a confessional.
I would.
Mm-hmm.
I just would, dude. Yep. And I've been in those churches, man. Them churches don't be having, like, people in them like that. So, it's like, it's very physically possible.
I've got a lot. Like I said, I've done some nasty things under a church roof before. It's like, I think when you grow up in a church, it becomes less sanctified because you be going there so much. So, you still have the allure, especially in, the main, you know, pulpit shit, you ain't trying to fuck up there. But like, I've like outside or like at the downstairs, you might have like a closet or storage room. I got it popping in.
Always a closet or
some room that you and whoever, you know, and it's mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I feel like the pastors be doing it. Fuck. Don't talk to me like I'm fucking stupid. But yeah, I would do it though.
Wow.
And I'm a Catholic. I really don't care.
Hey, man, did you do your face swap yet to see what you look like if you was a girl?
Nah, but some of y'all was looking hot.
All the niggas wind up looking good, and the girls look like, as Joe said, the girls look like the creepy niggas that be being in their DMs and shit. I was like, yeah. Oh, that's how they do look, too. All the niggas look, all the girly niggas
they
look
beautiful. How are you doing today?
Shut up, Marvin.
Oh, God. Niggas, go home, son. Get off the fucking computer.
I don't think I got nothing else to put in, man. It's that actor guy, Martin Bats Bradford. You can find me on all your social media platforms at Mr. Bats. Spell that Mr. out and you ain't gonna find me. Hit us up at theflywithbats@gmail.com as well as on YouTube, GumboMonster504. Hit up the ReviewingDatShow@gmail.com. It's ReviewingDat@gmail.com. Let us know anything you make us watch, we have to watch, whether we like it or not, and we will review it. You hear me? For this episode, for this side, I'm out.
And it's me, you hear me, boy, D-Mac. Catch me on Instagram at FrenchBread.Kid. Follow my clothing line at YourDig504. About to drop a major piece of merchandise. I'm very excited about that. And, yeah, life is good. See you on side B.
Posse Wine, it's your boy Alpha Joe, fresh out of the gumbo, still deep in the roux. And if you're out in the streets and you're looking for me, you can find me on IG Alpha Joe No E 504, bitch.
four.
See y'all on side B. We out here.
Like the army. Most real niggas know most niggas phony. Your shadow got your back, huh? Just like your homie. That's why shady niggas will harm thee. Just ask Caesar. Brutus got him and caught him before his last breather. If that don't make you believers, then you'll learn. Honesty is a quality that will burn, but it's cool. And trust is a quality you will earn. You a fool if you think you learned all of the rules. Imitating imitation and they calling it cool. I know a little bit, but go ahead and call me a fool. While you sprinkle sugar on shit and you calling it food. See, I'm just trying to groove and you standing on the wall with your hands on your balls making crab claws move. Trying to bonk at a dog, but I don't bonk. I just fall back till you think you winning, but you lost in the beginning. Ayy. One goal, one thing. One move and that shit don't change, it's her. Real niggas do real fucking things. Real niggas do. Ay, there's only one cool, one thing. One move and that shit don't change, and it's her. Real niggas do real fucking things. Real niggas do real fucking things. T.I. Z.Z.